Go ahead, John. And good evening once again, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Braveheart. 88.7 FM, Pennsylvania, American Patriot Radio, the small station with a big mouth. We got a veritable plethora of big mouths in here tonight. A thundering herd, if you will. Also, on camera, speaking of thundering herd, God, I hate that damn thing. I'm going to have to start wearing camouflage clothes, or I've got to go on a starvation diet. Gentlemen, are your microphones on? Because I didn't hear any clicks.
Yeah, they are.
Daryl?
Yeah, mine's on.
Okay, real good.
I was thinking it would help if I turned mine on, so I did it.
Couldn't
real
hurt.
Quiet.
No, don't do that. That way I don't know. I need to hear that click. Thank you, because okay. I can hear that back here now. That's the only way I know we've got it, okay? What the hell are you doing?
I'm practicing my levitation. The only thing I can get to work with my hands.
It's too much. There's just entirely too much. There's too many things I could say. I can't say any of them. I'm going to hush up. It's too early in the show for this.
You hush up? That's a new one.
Oh, she's going to start on me already?
Ouch.
All right, ooh. Food fight. Give me the peanut butter. Watch this. Oh, just for that? Taking my bottle of alcohol.
You got it? Okay.
All right. This is going to be a weird episode.
I think the first part was going to be.
Yeah, absolutely. All right. Like I said, we got multiple various and sundry big mouths here in the booth tonight. I am your host, Michael Wagner. I'll be with you here for the next 3 hours here in our Saturday get-together. It is AMR, Saturday, November 30th, middle of 2014. Over there. And plenty of time before Christmas to shop, all right?
You don't have to do it all Monday.
Or 1 hour. Woo-hoo-hoo. I got some things to say about that. We'll get that here in just a little bit. Sitting across from me, nursing a beer.
Nursing it? Hell, I'm drinking it.
I was going to say, you've damn near killed that one off. Good job. Not surprising either. My friend, brother, and partner in all things mischievous, the founder of Braveheart Radio, Mr. Daryl, sir. Here we go.
Here we stop.
I cannot whistle when I'm giggling, you bastard. Chad, what's the point? What's the point? Is there any point in Chad?
Not now.
Nope. Has there ever been?
Well, sure.
It ain't worked for 65 years or...
It ain't gonna work now. Nope. Sitting to my left, as one might expect, his friend and brother, comrade, political officer, and the tech guru here at Braveheart Radio, Peter John, Mr. John Lover.
Hi, hello, how are you?
And here, adding some civility to the proceedings here, is Daryl's better half. Kathy's in there. She's in the booth. Yeah. The seal of approval there. Exactly right. And the mini big mouth over here, making an appearance. I don't know if she's on camera or not.
She's not. She was on my lap.
Okay. Yeah. The itty bitty. All the other. 1, 2, 3. Hi, Lexi. There she is. She's making a rare appearance in the boot. So
for the time being,
me. Have fun. All right. Now. All right. You wanted to crack the bottle of champagne.
Yeah, for the wifey.
All right.
She said you have to crack the champagne. And
now, understand. People might not understand this. We do keep champagne flutes here in the studio. There's usually a good reason for it, or we can invent one.
Like tonight.
Well, actually, the last time we had champagne, Kathy wasn't here. She wasn't able to partake with us, so...
That was celebrating the Pirates making the playoffs.
And like I said, we'll do it as soon as we possibly can.
It's a good thing you did it then, because that's all you got to celebrate there.
What a hate thing! I have got absolutely no problem with how my Buccos finish the season.
Well, I don't either.
No problem at all. You know. Now, before we get any further, tonight's program is brought to you by the letters A, T, and F. Also brought to you by Connie and Sellers, Ice House Misty Bubbly, the official sparkling wine of the Pennsylvania American Patriot Radio Network. All right. Also by Coors Light, Once again, Coors Light, the official... Hold up, we're getting ready. Way to go. The official light beer of the Pennsylvania American Beacon Radio Network. That's what we got tonight. Smoke we ain't going to do for this until the second hour because there's no way I am subjecting Kath and the itty-bitty to three cigars fired up all at once. Besides, I want to actually be able to taste the food.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, we can hear you. Catch. Slow on the draw. Slow on the draw. All right, folks. This is always... I hate, absolutely hate, the plastic caps. Because they take an act of Congress to get out. You know how hard it is to get Congress to do anything.
Sometimes that's a good thing. Gridlock is bliss.
This one. There we go. Pull that out of there. No, pull it out of there.
Cramped up?
Hey.
Oh my god! I missed that too.
Wait a minute. That's an ice cooler. You missed the ice cooler?
Yeah, I did.
Wow. Okay. You're shut off.
Yeah. So you're shut off.
I didn't even get started yet.
Exactly. Apparently, you're already drunk from the contact buzz. Just pour these slowly. Folks, the drinking lamp is lit. And we hope you will be lit by the end of the show.
We're going to try to.
It's much more fun that way.
Much more goodly. As I explained to some hopefully new listeners tonight, I made a stop over in the Park Ave Plaza while I was getting the war wagon inspected. And happened to stop by Rolly's, which is a roll-in-your-own tobacco store. Now, normally, as we say, we've been doing our... And there we go. Don't suck off the top of this until I fill it, you jerk. Get out. Your ass. Anyway. We don't... John!
Sorry, I didn't... Sorry! My chair was stuck.
Yeah, well, you almost knocked the bottle out of my hand.
Alcohol abuse.
I would have killed him. I didn't say to kick his ass. I would have killed him.
Call the ATF.
There are worse things than death.
Yes, there are. Dishonor is definitely among them. Running out of booze is another. Let's see. The itty bitty don't get any of this, obviously.
But we have some pop-ups at the house.
Besides, to be honest, I don't think she'd like it.
And I'm not allowed to have
one. Oh, look at this.
Anyway.
There happens to be some in the bottom of the bottle. Darn.
I knew you'd come up with a remedy for that.
Remember the last time we did this? End of the world show?
Yeah.
Came up my damn nose?
Yeah.
I listened. Yeah.
All right.
That's why I love this stuff.
That's about a 9 on the Richter scale, isn't it?
Well, an 8.5, I would have given it an 8.5. All right. Gentlemen and lady.
Kathy?
Your glass. Your glass, my lady.
Thank you.
Seeing as how I don't know if we're going to get to before the new year. May God bless each and every one of us and this country one more time. Gotcha. There you go.
Bottoms up.
Not with champagne. I like to sip this. But the nice thing about this, Connie and Sellers Winery, local winery here, just outside of Connie Lake, Pennsylvania. Their sparkling wine there has become one of my favorite places. Sit there with a silly straw and kill one off all by my lonesome. All right. Opening rants, folks. Daryl, you were at a gun show in Ashtabula today. And this will be the last one at the Catherine Rose Convention Center because apparently the new owners have a bit of a snit when it comes to gun owners. And I'm not sure what their major malfunction is. We don't care. It has been moved.
Just a few minutes. Okay.
Exactly. Daryl, fill us in on the sitch. What's
well, it's going to be moved to the fairgrounds.
Do some coloring.
Right outside Ashtabula. It's about 4 miles south of 90 off of Route 45. That's how you can get to it from one direction there.
Bigger, smaller.
It'll be more room. You'll probably be able to get 175, maybe 200 tables.
The addition of the, expect we're gonna be able to? And we'll get that many vendors?
Yeah, oh yeah, he'll fill it if we are still having, able to have gun shows, but, you know.
You seem to have some doubts there, I don't.
Well,
they're not clamping down on us that hard, not yet.
Not yet, but things are happening up in New York.
Oh yeah, letters got sent out.
Yes.
We know you have this, you need to get rid of it now.
We need to talk about this then, because, New Yorkers, you need to start fighting back, this is,
So so just putting two and two together, if something starts in New York, it's gonna spread, okay?
Yes and no. Because I don't see a law like New York's ever getting passed in Pennsylvania.
But not necessarily that kind of spread. The disease is there. The rot is there.
I'm sure. However, I honestly don't believe Pennsylvanians will allow that stuff to go on.
Well, I know.
Personally, I'd like to see New Yorkers stand up and fight back.
There probably will be a lot of sorry ass representatives or state senators if they do pass that.
You know, the beauty is, it just proves us right, because in New York, you have to register your weapons.
Right.
And guess what? Now they're being confiscated.
We know you have
got
it. How do they know? Why? You filled out paperwork. What are you, stupid?
Mm-hmm. I hate to say it, we told you so, but...
We told you so! Mm-hmm.
I won't say that, no, but we told you so.
I'm not going to say it either, but we did tell you so.
Yeah.
Not.
Actually...
I'm not saying, I'm just saying.
Actually, I don't hate to say I told you so, because...
It does give you a certain sense of justification, you know? A certain sense of...
They're the idiots that didn't listen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You'll have that. This is going to be an excellent test bed.
And
last needs to be 8.
It evaporated.
Yep. You trying to savor anything is practically impossible, I think.
I'm like a cow. I chew it all into a cud, and then when nobody's looking, I bring it up and chew it later.
Ew. That is hot. Ew. let me say that again. Ew. What is this?
Mmm.
New interaction. What is this? What button? I'm tweeting one. Oh! Shep's on board. Okay. Excellent. I'm glad to see Shep's out there.
Yay! Shep! All right.
So
that's
anyway, just, getting back to the
guys. Yeah.
It was pretty busy this morning. I did pretty well for the morning, but as per usual, people have, I got a waiting list of stuff. I bought about 2,500 rounds of .22 ammo from a guy who sold a pistol and he had all this ammo.
That's amazing, because getting .22 ammo is practically impossible.
And as I've been telling everybody, I don't know if I had this information last week,
right?
But I was on the internet this week, and I was able to access CCI, and they have signed two contracts.
We did talk about this last week.
Okay.
But go ahead and update everybody.
They signed two contracts, one for 4 million rounds, or $4 million. Worth of 40 S&W for the Navy, and $17 million plus for another government entity, which I cannot remember.
Is anybody who might be connected with the Navy, can you please find out when they decided to go with the 40 Smith & Wesson? Because I was assuming they were using the same standard sidearm as the rest of our military.
They were using
the Beretta.
Yeah, they were using a 9mm there for a while, and they found that it came up short.
Well, we know that. And that doesn't mean they're going to do anything about it.
So they put out bids and stuff to try and get a new caliber.
The Navy on its own.
On its own. Okay. So somebody.
I'm surprised that went through.
Somebody sold them a bill of goods and is now getting them to buy. As far as we can tell right now, getting to buy 40 S&W, regardless of what gun it is.
40 Smith & Wesson is a fine round. I would personally rather have that than a 9. But the whole theory being shot placement and firepower over, you know, magazine capacity. Mm-hmm. It will eliminate the spray and pray to an extent, especially if the bad guy goes down instead of absorbs several. One of our regular trainers in the 3% has had an argument about what he carries, and he carries a 9. And he says, rather than a slab side 45, he prefers the 9mm, and he lays out a good argument for it. And as soon I'm going to track down that article, I'm going to bring it in. I want to run it past you and your experience and see if it makes sense. But this is a guy that's he's been in combat repeatedly. Guy's nuts, he volunteers for it. And he lays out a reason why he prefers the 9 in combat. And so
my personal trainer,
yeah,
has a decal on the back window of his car. Which, by the way, I don't know if I've ever told you this, but he is a Glock aficionado as well.
I am losing my reluctance towards Glock. I will probably still never purchase one, simply because I really don't want to buy new guns.
Yeah. But the decal says 45 ACP, because shooting more than once is just silly.
Welcome to my world. But again, the article I read was laid out a really good case for the 9. And after I read it, I actually started thinking a little bit differently myself. But mm-hmm. I need to run past a few more experienced experts. This guy over here. Be that as it may, Rayvon McDuff.
Well, anyway, according to finish up the CCI
yep.
Thing, they claim that it's going to take until 2018 to fulfill the contract.
And this is a military contract.
Military, there's two contracts, one for the Navy and one for a government entity.
Now,
The government entity, the other government entity is the one that's a big one. That's $17+ million. But I forget who it was for. So, be that as it may.
A little disturbing. The government is buying up the production capacity so that the civilian market can't access it other than imports. And imports can be blocked by, you know, presidential, you know, fiat.
I'm wondering, is that ball nose ammo or is that hollow points?
It did not say whether it was hollow points or ball. Okay, it just said 40S&W. And the two departments and roughly how much it were. It was over $21 million. So, be that as that goes. But all in all, the gun show was fairly good.
A lot of people through?
I don't know how many, but up until about noon, 1 o'clock, it was pretty steady. A lot heavier than I've seen it for other shows for that time period of the morning.
Christmas shopping? Or?
No, there was people out there that were topping off. I got this gun and I need a couple more clips. I need a little bit of ammo. I don't have enough. And, you know, that kind of stuff. And
we are still seeing that.
And they're still shocked about the 22s not being available.
I don't get this. How long has this been going on?
Yeah, well, we know the 22s haven't been available now for a year.
At least.
Damn near. Okay.
And
I don't
then the guys, then they're saying,
where have you been? Have you not been paying attention to what's going on around you?
Yeah, you know.
Do you have your head so far up your rear defilade you don't understand what's happening here?
And for about the last 2 years, we've been telling people, when you go to the store, we don't care what caliber of ammo you've got or what caliber you buy. You get paid, you go to the store, you buy a box of ammo.
Yeah.
And therein lies another one of those, I told you so.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
It seems to me there's going to be a few of those tonight.
This is going to be an ongoing theme, I think, for the next several months.
Because
the regime now is, well, they've removed the optics. There's no doubting anymore. And if you still cannot see what's going on when it's right in front of your face, I can't help you. And you will be left behind. I am not going to come to your aid.
Two words. Human shield.
Yeah. Now, I used to have some delusions about trying to liberate the FEMA camps when the things got ugly. I don't know if I want to anymore. See, if you're stupid enough to end up in one of those, you pretty much deserve your fate. Mm-hmm. I'll think about that when the time comes, if I'm still alive to do anything about it.
The only ones that I would try to rescue would be the ones that actually put up some resistance.
I don't, they're not going to be in the main camps, they're probably going to be disappeared.
Yeah, they'll be put in a different camp.
Because I think the FEMA camps are going
to
be more for...
You go in and check in, but you don't check out. Yeah.
The FEMA camps are more going to be for... we have food and warm beds and clean clothing. Please come to us. Turn in your weapons. We have food and clean clothing and warm beds. Please come to us. When everything comes crashing down and people are on the verge of starvation.
I can just see it now. New York State will be full of them. Just bring your AR-15 and we will give you free housing and food. That's all it costs you is your AR-15.
Yeah, all costs is your liberty. Nice. Real nice.
Yep.
We need to put together a list of all the self-storage facilities on this side of the New York border and distribute them. Because we know you have this, you need to turn it in. Oh, I sold that, man.
the option is to... basically, the requirement is get it out of the state by any means necessary. But the caveat to that is, even though long guns, you don't have to create any paperwork, they're probably going to demand to see proof that you actually sold the weapon.
Well,
there's got to be a way to do that.
There is. You go down to the local Staples store, buy a package of receipts.
Yeah.
Okay, I know where this is going.
Okay.
So do I.
And you just put on there, received from so-and-so, one AR-15.
Received from Thomas Jefferson. Mm-hmm. Received from George Washington.
Abraham Lincoln. In fact, we got
several. Not so much Abe.
Several from Abraham
Lincoln. You know I've got a problem with Abe.
Well, yeah, I know. But know, after all, he had to supply 11 million troops, so he turned in 11 million of those AR-15s.
Wait a minute.
Never mind.
Back to the task at
hand. Yeah.
Dicking out cheese and pepperoni.
Hey, don't be selfish with that stuff. Pass it over.
Now, just hang on there, guys. Hang on there. Leave everything. Leave everything. Nothing will be left behind. No, I'm saying leave everything.
Well, I'm leaving this.
Okay, but leave nothing behind.
There you go.
This cracker seems to have slipped out.
It's seen better days.
Where's Layla? Ruff, ruff. She's up in the mountains.
Oh.
Yep. The tramp's out running.
Wait a minute. With the sun?
Yeah.
All right. Technically, I guess it is still his dog.
Technically. But,
Notice I got a laugh out of Kathy with that. Yeah, huh?
It's Monday, his son is going in to have an ankle operated on. So he's going to miss hunting season. He wanted to go up to camp one more time.
Got to have the putty.
So, yeah, got to take the putty.
Got to take the putty, so. All right, speak out, Kath. It doesn't matter. You can't. You're on camera. You are not hiding from anybody. Just speak.
They don't know sign language by Kathy.
So let's do this, all right? All right.
Okay.
Which means butt. All right.
In case you didn't understand that, folks, that was hit a blooper to center field on the third pitch.
See, we're not on the same pitch. We're not on the same page. I was telling them to butt. All right. You're just going to continue to stuff your face.
What?
All right. What?
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 I can't hear you. My mouth is full.
You wait till I tell our waitress. We got to track her down, too.
Speaking of waitresses, if the local brewery beer places in town,
the microbreweries.
Serve food, and if they're open after the radio program.
I've never been to any of the micros around here.
I haven't either, but I thought we might like to visit some evening just to say.
Well, I would love to.
After 9 o'clock. So we need to do some homework and find out. So
I'm on the road Monday through Friday, so that kind of behooves somebody else. Look into the local situation.
I think you just got elected.
Therefore, see, now
you brought the whole issue to the floor. I hereby nominate Kathy Sivick as the chairman of the research committee. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? I didn't think so. Perfect. Motion carried. You're in charge.
Will you
just volunteered your ass. You realize that, don't you?
Well, that's all right, but will you volunteer if I find out to accompany me so I won't be alone?
It's going to be on the weekend. You know that.
Oh, I know that.
Why would you be alone if we go?
She wants to do the research. She's going to do a recon in person.
Yeah.
Instead of recon by fire, which is a good thing. You really don't want to shoot
down,
up the bar.
I'll go down and help her out by recon.
Yeah, we have to go there at least once.
You'll be reconning by taste. I know you.
Mm-hmm. I just come in off.
That's a good place.
I just come in off the desert and I'm a little dehydrated. I need 4 or 5 gallons. You got some?
Of wild turkey, no less.
Yeah.
Be sure and turn
off. Hell no.
Be sure and turn off the heater.
5 gallons of wild turkey.
Get done and bring up the pan.
Oh, mother of God.
And the lid and the peanut butter.
All right.
Okay, I guess I got all those instructions. If not,
we've got it on tape. We've got recording.
We've got it covered.
No problem.
Cap. Okay. The audience out there will remind us at the end of the show with about 10,000 tweets.
What makes you think they know what the hell is going on?
I don't know.
So Kath is on her way out of here. The itty bitty is going bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
And I will see you when we're done, okay?
And by the way, Mother, thank you for bringing down the goodies.
You're welcome.
Love you, baby.
Bye, Daddy. Love you.
It's so cool. Yeah, we locked everybody out, aren't we?
For everybody in, one or the other.
Well, keep the animals locked inside. I understand that.
Six of one, half dozen the other.
All right. The door is latched?
It is latched.
All right, the women folk are gone. Now we can start acting like we're supposed to.
I'm surprised you waited this long.
That was perfect.
She pissed her cock fucking motherfucking tits. All right.
That was good. The hat turned sideways.
I had to do it, man.
That was awesome.
Hey, John.
Yo.
Smile. Let me see your teeth. Smile. Let me see
what teeth?
Exactly.
That's it. Okay. Good.
Why?
I'm doing some research and I just needed to.
What did I just do?
I don't know.
I don't either, but I'm scared.
Oh my.
Hold me. Damn, dude. I didn't think I'd get that big of a rise out of you.
It's too much. It's too much. Circuit overload, there's entirely too many responses there that no.
Does not compute.
No, it computed entirely too much. All right. Once again, tomorrow, one more time, Catherine Rose Convention Center, Ashtabula, Ohio. Get up there. Get your tactical reloads and practically anything you need. If you don't have a fighting weapon at you, a stupid motherfucker.
There's a lot of them there, too. Overpriced, though.
Everything overpriced, bro. Did you actually make it to the show?
Yeah.
No kidding. All right.
Anyway, that's nice of life.
Okay, anything else you got? We're going to switch over to John.
Go ahead.
Switch over to John. John, how was your week?
Fairly normal, working like an idiot. Minimum.
that word.
Of 10 hours a day, more like 11 or 12. It's coming at a good time of the year, though. I'm tired. I do, however, I'm in the middle of a 4-day weekend. Of course, we have Thursday off. Friday, the shop is open, but I save one vacation day a year, the day after Thanksgiving. I don't care if I go 6 months without a day off. There is one day set aside for the day after Thanksgiving. For no other reason than I've done it my entire adult life and I'm not going to stop now. So,
good call.
I did go to the gun show today. I took Lexi with me.
Was she bored out of her mind?
No, actually she made out like a little bandit. people were giving her free shit all over the place.
Okay, it's usually one of two scenarios. You come through with an itty bitty, and either this child has never been disciplined its entire life, and is just your first instinct is, you know, to silence the bleating little lamb. Here's the instruction manual: place the pillow firmly over its face and push. All right, yeah, I'm a dick. Deal with it. Or you get somebody like the itty bitty here, who just. She fits in. She's part of the gun culture, man.
She is.
This is a 5-year-old that can field strip and clean the Glock.
Yep.
Which is... Dude, when I was 5 years old, I was still eating dirt. All right? So it's a little ridiculous. Kids are entirely
She's changed dirt. She's a new generation of kids here.
She's
she
got...
She now chews on burnt gunpowder.
Look at who she's got for a dad and two uncles.
Well,
I mean, it's kind of a no-brainer when you look at it that way.
Indeed.
Which she is going to so outpace us.
Man. Oh, man. Dude. Anyway.
Frightening.
Well, if nothing else, we'll leave a legacy by the name of Lexi.
I knew that you were going to stumble over that. That was actually pretty damn
good. That was actually good, yeah.
I like that one.
I was within seconds today of...
Piggy, it's extended by you.
Etiquette.
Eddie quit a long time ago.
Yeah, well, that's his problem, not mine. Mm-hmm. Fuck it.
You're going to make yourself snarf. I was within seconds today of walking out of there with a Remington 870 with a collapsible stock pistol grip. Let's go.
Why didn't you?
Truck problems.
I would not have woke up tomorrow morning. And yeah,
I entirely forgot about that. You're right.
Yeah, and truck problems. Primarily, I wouldn't have woke up tomorrow morning.
Ah, yes.
Because.
Roberta.
Because.
She would have beaten you to a bloody pulp.
Because of the truck problems. But it was a sweet deal. Guy walked into it with a slung over. Walked into the show. With a slung over his shoulder. I happened to be right there at the entrance looking at other things, and he came in. And I didn't even say anything to him. He just kind of caught me staring. And it had a Hastings rifle barrel on it.
An enchanted moment.
Yes. It had a Hastings rifle barrel on it, which means it was a slug gun.
Yes.
I saw that. Nice looking gun.
Yeah, it was. Remington 870. About a 20-inch barrel. Very, very, very good weapon for home defense.
What was he asking?
350. And I'm kicking myself.
Oh, I don't even need another gun and I would have done that.
And
for no other reason to put it on the table in a couple of weeks.
And the 12-gauge, even the 20-gauge, slug and double aught butt are the most overlooked ammunition there is when it comes for defense.
Well, see, the thing is, being that this was a rifled barrel, and I don't know that much about shotguns. The gentleman that had it explained this to me. Because it was a rifled barrel, I could put shot through it, but it would destroy the rifling.
Exactly, you really don't want to.
So I could just as easily go get a stock 870 barrel and throw it on there, and
sure,
it would be all good.
Do you still make the pumpkin balls?
Yeah, they have slugs. They call them slugs now. They don't call them pumpkin balls.
Well, to me, it's
you can get them.
There's rifled. See the way I always.
There's rifled slugs, and then there is regular slugs.
Okay,
and then there's Zabbits.
Okay, to me, it's rifled slugs or pumpkin balls. That's just the way I grew up.
Yep,
and I still call it that way. And
well,
so,
what they've done is instead of having a round ball like the pumpkin ball,
right.
They have the slug, which is hollow at the base, round in the front, hollow at the base, that swells up with the gas to engage the sides of the barrel and goes down through, whether it's rifled or not rifled.
It was a pump. Probably the only thing I would have done had I bought the thing is I would have taken the scope off, because it was. I want to say it was a 3 or 4 power scope. Why
that's not necessary for close-in work.
Yeah.
That's kind of unusual.
I would have taken that off and maybe put a holographic on it, but maybe not. And I would have probably put a forward post on the jack off.
Hence his nickname.
Yeah. This is
350.
I did not have the cash on me.
Yeah. Otherwise, you'd have it in hand.
I did, basically. But I did, however, have an ATM card and a credit card. I did not want to use. I didn't want to create a paper trail. Put it that way. When I left, I told myself, I was kicking myself going down the street. I'm like, fuck. And I told myself, if I see a PNC bank, I'm going back and getting that gun.
Right.
Because my ATM, and it's so silly. I mean, I of course I can use any ATM, but if I use a PNC ATM, I don't get charged any fees. So that was the.
I realized.
If I would have seen the PNC, I'd have been.
I realize there are some people out there that still freak out over the.
But that wasn't it. That was just a stupid stipulation that I put on.
I understand that, and I know.
I probably passed two dozen.
And there still wouldn't have been a paper trail because he
doesn't like the idea of paying a fee to get access to his
own money. No, Mike, that's not it.
Really?
Yeah, that wasn't it. That was just a stupid stipulation that I put on.
It was enough to keep you from doing it.
It was enough to keep me from doing it, and you know, probably for the better, because like I said, I'd be speaking my last words tonight.
We would have to change his name to Bobby.
If it wasn't.
It would be worse than that.
If it was not for the fact that I've got an unknown amount of money yet to dump into my truck to get it back on the road, I would have that gun now.
Right.
In a heartbeat. But the bottom line is, I've got what some may consider too many. I marginally consider enough. What you would say is not enough guns. I need transportation.
Indeed.
But that was hard to pass up.
Sometimes you have to rearrange your priorities, and in this particular case, fixing the damn truck. So you have a means of getting out of town.
Yeah.
See, I didn't have
a priority.
I did not need the AR I picked up. I never would have thought that an AR was an impulse buy item. However, that's the only way I can describe how I got that damn gun. Mm-hmm. It was there, and I said, okay. It's like handing the candy bars next to the checkout counter.
Yeah.
The worst.
That's not something you do with a $600 weapon. However, that's the way I treated it.
The worst. So what kind of candy bar was it?
What do you mean? You've seen it.
No, but in your mind.
No. No, it was an AR flavor candy bar. I'm sorry.
the sad part was we just spent 15 minutes before in the back room discussing how much it would cost to put an AR-15 together.
What was the price difference? About $50
at the most.
Yeah.
At the most, really.
Buy one that
did make. There were a few. There are a few accessories I would have liked to have had otherwise. However, be that as it may.
Yeah, I'm still kicking myself.
Bless you, sir.
Because I'm in the market for a home defense shotgun.
I know you've been talking about the shotgun for a while.
And this had everything I wanted. Collapsible stock, pistol grip.
Oh, no, right now.
And it was a Remington 870, which means parts and accessories fall out of the sky for these things.
Hell, at one time the military had surplus bolts that you could buy for next to nothing, for a spare, before all this shit hit.
But
you pick up a bolt for like $20.
It's not the last one I'll come across, and maybe the next time I do come across one, I'll be in a position to buy it.
Okay.
But that was damn hard to pass up.
Now was not the proper time. All right, anything else this week?
No.
Okay. My week was trying. I have never before driven a truck that would freeze up in as seemingly as warm a temperatures as this piece of shit does. Normally, I don't have to deal with frozen airlines until it gets into the single digits or less. This thing gets down into the mid-20s, and I have to start thawing out airlines on this truck.
Don't you have an air dryer on it?
We just replaced the cartridge on it, and it still doesn't seem to be doing a damn thing. Yeah. In the past week, I have learned every joint in the airlines of that truck that could possibly need heat in order to thaw it out. I have discovered them all. All.
What are the hard parts?
All?
The hard part's done.
Every single one. The only thing I didn't do was mark them with paint so I could find them in the dark. Because I refused to. I'll wait until it turns daylight. They can just wait for the damn truckload. And up until this past week, they have not been stocking the air brake antifreeze on the shelves. I don't know if you're familiar.
No. It's never heard of that.
Air brake antifreeze. It's big in Canada because, of course, they got to deal with it a lot more than us. And in the northern states, basically, it's a quart bottle of either methyl or isopropyl alcohol with a few rust preventatives added to it. You pour it into the airline, attach it back to the tractor, or depending on where you're breaking the line, and the air compressor pushes it through the airlines, thawing out any ice blockages that may be and cleaning out the airline. And your truck runs again. But the problem is, every time there's an elbow or fitting, especially the brass fittings here and there that they like to use on them, anytime there's an elbow, that's a place where moisture can build up and eventually freeze up and block the flow of air. And there's a handful of places on that truck where it is chronic. And I now know where each one of them is. And for those, before antifreeze will work, you have to take a propane torch to them. Heat them up, thaw out the ice blockage, air pushes on through, then you throw the alcohol in it to clean out the rest of
it. Yeah, the air's got to flow first.
Exactly. So if for some reason your brakes are slow or your air suspension in the back on your trailer is dropping down, and you can feel it. There's a big difference when the airbags are deflated. A lot more bouncy, a lot harder. Okay, you pull over to the side. Break the glad hand. Take a look. How much air is coming out of there? Damn, that ain't flowing worth a... Okay, set that off to the side. Hit a couple of the elbows on the tractor with the torch until you see ice chips start to fly out of the air. Yeah, it'll do that. And eventually when it's blowing good and hard and the compressor's keeping up with it, all right, shut off the air. If the trailer hasn't been inflating properly, okay, just to make sure, you pour maybe a pint into the glad hand, flows down into the line, reconnect it, fire the truck back up, blow it back through. Now you've cleaned out all the trailer airlines. Everything works again. Until the next time you get a moisture buildup. Air dryers on the tractor trailer is supposed to work. I heard a guy here not too long ago say, air dryers were designed for people who don't like to bleed their air tanks.
Well, yeah, that helps.
And it just, this thing creates moisture and just, I've never had a truck that was such a pain in the ass. It's a 97 International, and the trailer's about as old, and I don't know what it is, but this is going to be a long damn winter, because when I started driving this guy's truck, it was back in March or April, I think it was, when I started with him, so I was out of the ugly weather for the year.
Right.
We're just now getting into it, and it looks like it's going to be either a typical or somewhat colder than normal winter, which means I'm going to be doing this a lot. I now have a gallon of airline antifreeze.
Wow.
In the truck. I've managed to find enough, and I'm stockpiling it. When I find enough, I'm going to buy another case. And I was going to buy a torch at Walmart Friday. That was a non-stop. I'm sorry. I couldn't have got into there with a shoehorn. Or maybe a daisy cutter explosive to clear me a place.
I considered, God only knows why, but I considered going to Walmart on yesterday to buy the webcam that we're not using, by the way.
Oh, yeah, I was wondering what the situation was on that.
Later. I'm still too pissed off.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
We need to talk about that.
We do.
And to buy my latest toy. Hmm. That, yeah. Anyway.
As you blind all our viewers.
Oh, I can't see. I was gonna go, but then I ran across a couple of news stories.
Okay.
Of the typical animals
mm-hmm.
that are out for Black Friday, and quickly came to the conclusion that I would never get my shopping done because I'd be too busy shooting people.
I was going to say, not only would you not get your shopping done, but you'd be busy. Now I know why you would be.
There,
wouldn't get it done.
There is one day a year. There's one day a year that
blocked.
That makes me ashamed of my fellow Americans.
Mm.
And that is Black Friday, when the idiots get out there at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Oh my God.
And stand in front of a place, and when they open the doors, cause massive mayhem and pushing and shoving to get in there.
Now mind you, I've got...
That is absolute idiocy on the part of the American shopper.
I have got
There's
no...
There's plenty to go around, folks. You don't have to kill anybody to get there.
I have
Unless,
got
of course,
no respect.
You've got some shit you want to get, some people you want to get rid of. Then you kill them and claim it was an accident. Ran over them at the...
Or feed them to things.
Walmart or whatever.
I have got no respect for these animals, and that's exactly what they are.
Now the
fact that I was going to go on Black Friday, don't lump me in with those, because I wasn't going looking for bargains. I had two very specific items
indeed
that I was going to get. I didn't care how much I paid for them. I had a rough idea what I was going to pay for them anyway.
Right.
Difference between your typical bargain hunter and a guy that's just got to listen.
Yeah.
Go get my stuff and get out.
Yeah.
I don't shop. I do not shop.
I don't either. My wife gets mad at me because I go in with a list of two or three things and get it and I'm gone.
And we you remember,
well, didn't you look around? No. Why not? Because I wasn't looking for anything else. And they don't get it. They do not
you
get
remember,
it.
You remember a couple weeks ago you read that thing by...
Fred.
Yes.
The difference between men and women.
Yeah.
And I ended the show with, how do you explain shopping?
Yes.
Exactly.
Men know what they want before they even step off the porch.
Yeah. Well,
they
isn't
go,
that kind of the idea?
They go. They know where to find it. They get it. They may compare one to the other for about 2 seconds. They get it. They
the
go
only,
for it.
The only time,
they go home.
The only time guys will shop is if you go to get what you had in mind and you look at it. Man, that seems a lot of awful expensive.
Yeah.
Exactly. And you start to think about it. Can I get that cheaper someplace? And then you will go. But you got the item in mind.
Now,
women will... Oh, look at that.
There is an exception. Men...
I'm almost afraid to ask.
Men will shop at gun shows.
I would like to say that's different, but I really can't.
You can't!
No, I can't.
You can't.
No,
but that is the one time that men shop.
But there is a slight difference, though.
Okay, and a caveat to that? Not a caveat, maybe, but ancillary to it. Ever been into a Cabela's?
No, but I've been in Bass Pro.
Okay, you get the idea.
Out.
Yeah, okay. Same concept. That's what women call shopping.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yes.
You're just a
I'm sorry. Man. You, my friend, and I.
Hi, my name is Mike.
I've gone shopping. Hi, Mike.
Okay.
12-step program. Here we come.
All right.
12 steps from that.
Seriously, dude.
To the next one.
Seriously, if you've ever been into Gander Mountain, Bass Pro, Cabela's, you shopped. That is shopping. To go in and look at shit that you have no intention of buying, saying, I would really like to buy. That is shopping.
No.
Yes, I'm sorry, John. I hate to break it to you.
But there is a difference between shopping at a gun show.
I want to hear how you're going to justify this. You got two minutes, man, because we're up against it.
Because the fact of the matter is, when you go to a gun show, it's full of what? Guns, knives, clips, ammunition.
This doesn't the other thing, really? No shit. Okay.
And the occasional thingamabobber. And a whatchamacallit.
And a doohickey.
Yeah.
Lots of doohickeys.
And so maybe one.
And round to-its.
And to-its and jeans. And rings.
And
gazintas. Where did it go?
Occasionally, you need to look for a gazinta.
Yeah.
I forgot about the gazintas.
So you're trying.
Okay, he's got something. Hold on, because we're up against it.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay, Sandra.
Hi, Sandy.
Hi, Sandra.
Please don't lump all women together. I hate shopping. All kinds. Very, very true.
You're not around long enough for us to figure that one out.
Yeah.
Get your butt up here.
When they don't you shopping before, so how are we supposed to know?
How the hell are you going to get a hold of your tinfoil hat with sparkles if you don't get your butt up?
Sparkles.
And on that note, we got to take a bit of a break. I think we need to unass the area before a napalm strike comes in here. You listen to Pennsylvania American Patriot Radio. Braveheart. 88.7 FM. But we're an ass in the area. We'll be back.
I'm out of here. Later.
Oh, Sandra, you know we love you.
Of course. Hey, if we can't pick on family, who can we pick on?
Exactly.
Just another fellow squirrel.
let's see here.
With squirrel tits.
You weren't supposed to know this.
One of these nights, like
you. Holy shit! You've got 10 people watching this.
Uh-oh.
Here it comes. There it comes.
Have you throw in Red Skeleton and his Pledge of Allegiance.
I might do that in the next hour.
My tinfoil hat with sparkles. I need it. It's here waiting for you, dear.
You gotta come and get it. You gotta come and get it, baby girl.
No, we try to send it to you down there, it'll set up all the radar, and no, it won't let it get
you.
No.
If she comes up and gets it, she will have to, if she takes it with her, she's got to wear it while she's on the squirrel cam.
Yeah.
She's got to visit us via Skype, and it has to, somehow we got to connect her to the squirrel cam. That's something else, we got to mention the squirrel cam tonight, because I haven't talked about it. Where the hell was I? I don't know. Hang on. Let me finish ramping this up here.
That's right.
I got some metal for the second hour surprise. I'll introduce the band.
You know what's really cool?
Snow?
Sandra's been there. Yeah, too. Oh, wait.
I am Dirk.
Okay. I know you love that.
Oh, dude. Look what's been out of the human station with the humidor.
Check to see if this is mine or not.
Oh, there is another one. Okay. Well, can I have that one?
This was mine, but go ahead.
No, if that's yours,
by all means.
No crash.
It transferred over. I don't believe it.
No, what's really great is folks like Sandra and Shep and Jack. You know, they're not participating as much tonight on Twitter.
Right.
But they're there.
They seem to be listening and catching things.
They are there. They're always there. And God, we love you guys for that so much. You're always there for us. Here's to you.
Indeed. I need to stop. We asked if you wanted one.
I was just going along with it. Imaginary. You know, I practice levitation here.
We're going to get into this before the night's over.
Must we?
I told Mother today I was going to...
You'll like this.
I told Mother today I was going to pull that on you.
Am I looking rather dapper tonight?
I will say, you are the cleanest I've seen you in a long time.
A little makeup would go far.
Understand what I'm saying? That was harsh.
The delayed reaction made that moment. Anyway, go on.
No,
you hush.
You know what I got to say about that?
Yeah.
Fuck you.
But
y'all just been flipped off in a whole shitload of different languages.
I'm trying to get the camera right.
Okay. Now, what were you saying? Tell me more about me. I seem to be in rare form tonight.
No, that line, I've used to use that line.
That is from Aladdin.
Yeah, I used to use it. But no, the beard is well trimmed. The hair is cut properly. You've got a decent shave on. You realize that the next time you and I show up someplace, we're going to be mistaken for brothers again.
More or less.
Yeah.
More or less.
Poor guys.
Hey, yeah, I got no problem with that.
Yeah, me neither.
This guy's my brother by choice.
Yeah. Brother from another mother.
Like they used to say, you can choose your friends, but you can't choose your family. Brother by choice.
Ah, yes.
And of course,
hey, I'm not
excellent choice in facial hair.
I'm actually considering growing my hair out.
You'd pull Steven Seagal and I'll kick you in the balls.
No. No, not.
I don't think your hair is. Yours wouldn't get away with it.
Dude, I used to have normal hair.
Really? I call that normal.
Okay, 80s hair.
You didn't have a mullet, did you?
Yeah. In the 80s, when it was fashionable.
It was never fashionable to me. I never had a mullet. I had a full on.
I had a duck's ass.
I had a full on mane. I had metal hair.
So did I at one point. That's
alike. Band is called Silent Force. They did four albums between 99 and 2007. This is from the 2007 album called Walk the Earth. The song is called King of Fools. It was put together, it's a German power metal band with it has elements of progressive metal and neoclassical involved in it. Prog metal is basically what I listen to for the most part. These were. You can hear the musicianship. There's actual harmony in the voices, which is. And unfortunately, 2007 was the last album for this lineup. They released a new album this year. The guitarist got a whole new group of people together with them, and I have not had a chance to taste it yet. But we'll find out.
I gotta have one, guys. Mike?
Smoke up tonight?
No.
Mike?
No, you go ahead.
You sure?
Yeah, go ahead and smoke.
Alright.
I may grab one later.
This is becoming a weekly thing for me now. These are good cigars, man.
My work here is done.
Whenever you corrupt somebody,
what do we need?
Okay, this. You're gonna have to, after the show, you're gonna have to tell me what to do with this.
Well, that's very simple. Self-explanatory. Take the cap off. And it looks like, yeah, this is the new one I brought with me. When it gets down to this level, when it's shrunk down to that level, that's when you're supposed to add water. You add water up to this line. Leave it alone. And the thing will expand all the way up to the top. It's fully charged. Stick it in a humidor, you're done.
That humidor you got me, I either looked at it or got it. Okay.
We'll talk about it here. We'll talk about cigars here in a minute. And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. You're listening to the second hour of Pennsylvania American Patriot Radio, Braveheart, 88.7 FM here in lovely Newville, Pennsylvania, where we are going to take a look. What is the temperature? Do I know? Do I care? Hell no. 31 31?
Yeah, it's supposed to...
Honest and for true?
Yeah, we're on a warming trend.
Global warming! Oh my god! The polar bears! Ha ha ha! The polar bears! Alright, fuck that.
Instead of walking on the ice, you're going to have to swim through that ice-cold water to catch their daily rations.
How heartless can you be?
Oh, I'm talking about mean, cruelty, animal cruelty. We all ought to be arrested and put in jail.
We're going to be arrested and put in jail for something. We might as well have the... You know, I just realized that you actually mounted the damn heater on the wall.
Yes.
That's cool as shit, ain't it?
Yeah, it is. And it took me this long to figure the shit out. All right. Real observant, dude. Far out.
Mother had me come down here and do a neatness so we could set to bring, bring a
that's
a
the only way that was
going
to happen. Yeah.
Real quick.
Here we go.
Jack chimed in. You're still fighting the turkey coma and hangover from yesterday, so I'm in slow mo today.
Hey,
Jack, we know you're there. We love you, brother. Thank
copy
you.
That, bro. No doubt.
Who was that, Jack, you said?
Jack, yeah, that was Jack.
I've got the perfect cure for that, Jack. It's three fingers of wild turkey. Straighten you right up.
Anyway. John here is partaking of some second hour smokage. I haven't bothered yet. Got entirely too much food to eat yet. As if I really needed any goddamn camera. Anyhow, I'm sitting here feeding my face.
There he is. That's him.
Hey, John. Fuck yeah, mate. You ain't with adults. Quadraphonic sound. Dude.
Damn. Two hands and two nipples. Holy shit.
What the hell are you looking at? Now I'm concerned. All right. Be that as it may. All right. Top of the hour for the second hour surprise. You heard. Silent Force is a power metal band out of Germany. They did four albums between 99 and 2007. That was from the 2007 cut, Walk the Earth. It is currently my number one album on rotation in my vehicles. A lot of good stuff there. That one was King of Fools. The hell of it is, and a lot of reviewers have said this about the band, in 2007, they finally hit their stride. They got everything down right, the instrument, the musicality, the vocals, everything. And then they all went to different bands. They all had different gigs to do. And it's a shame because they were really hitting their stride with this stuff. However, this year, lead guitarist, and as you might guess with most prog metal bands, is the guitarist that is the center of any of these bands. He got a whole new lineup, and in 2013, new release, Silent Force. I have not had a chance to check it out yet. If you get the chance, by all means do so. If you are of that mind, and like I said, right now, prog metal, power metal, that sort of thing, that's what Mikey listens to most of. But again, as you've seen here over the past few weeks, I listen a little bit of everything. And we'll be surprising you here in the weeks to come. We start out the show tonight with Kai Kara. What more do you need to know? All right, John.
Yo.
Thank you for helping to perfume the air with lovely smoke.
Odorous of tobacco.
I am. It's getting to the point.
That does smell good. I paid $2 for the night's over.
It is getting to the point.
Yes.
That I'm actually jonesing for one of these every week.
My work here is done. My work is done. And the great thing about this is, what'd you do?
I don't know. I took the plastic off and I got one with holes in it and one without.
Well, the one with holes was just to keep the thing from drying out completely. This is the one that you have to have at the top so that the humidity gets out.
Okay.
So, that's just basically a shipping container there. John is experimenting with the Humitube. It is a gel-filled humidification device with cigars, incubators, and, apparently, I left one that I purchased here last week, and I'm gonna let. He's just gotta have it for it because he doesn't have anything in the humidor he got, and we've got one here and the one in the studio, and along with another pack that helps to regulate it at exactly 70% humidity, so the smokes are staying good, and it really smells good tonight. I may grab one before the night's over. You found yourself really starting to enjoy the smoke.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I doubt that I would partake much outside of here.
You really don't... you get to here once a week. That's once or twice a month is generally all I ever do because that's all the time I have to really enjoy one. Mm. And easy, bro. Did I mention this on the air?
Not yet.
Okay. I was going to get to this in the first hour, but we had other things to take care of, including drinking champagne and eating food, and the itty-bitty was here, and Daryl's better half.
Mrs. Daryl is here.
Yes. I was getting the war wagon inspected today, and not too far from where that was happening was another smoke shop. Now, normally, as we say here, smoker-friendly is the one we normally partake of here in town. But there was Rolly's Tobacco Stop Shop and Roll. It is a roll-your-own location, and there's a lot of these popping up all over the place. And where you buy your bulk tobacco, roll your own cigarettes, and cut a hell of a lot of cost out of it. If you've got the time to actually do it, you buy yourself a little machine, or you can use machinery that is there and rent it. And it's automated. And you can make yourself up a carton as you're going. And just load buy this stuff, put the tobacco in the machine, and let it rock. And when you're done, you pay them for whatever cost to rent the machine, and you've got yourself a carton of smokes, so out you go. And you can save like half off what you normally would pay for a carton of smokes. Yeah, John's gears are turning. I can see that right now. Jeez. What are you doing?
I'm
something is wrong.
Yeah, I just
we need to open up the second window because the smoke is.
The wireless connection to Daryl's internet is somewhat less than reliable.
Why did it shut off?
How much have we lost?
We haven't lost anything as far as I can tell. And nobody has complained.
Indeed.
So, we'll see.
Okay. Is there something we can beef that up?
I'm working on that.
Okay.
I've been working on that.
Okay. We'll talk about that in a second. Anyway, once again, Rolly's. Went over there, checked the place out. They are in a small corner shop in the Park Avenue Plaza here in Meadville. And if they seem to be doing a decent business. Had quite a number of people in and out of there while I was there. But man, if you're looking for drive-by traffic, you ain't going to get it in this little location. They're right in the corner where you would not go unless you were there on purpose to go there. Kind of a shame, too, because they had some really interesting stuff there. They are unofficially 420 friendly, to those who understand. Okay, we're going to let it go at that. The whole hookah pipe thing, which seems to be fairly popular now. They take care of that. Oils and things that go into the hookah. I'm not sure how that whole thing works. The variety of roll-your-own tobacco that is available there, I have never seen this kind of quantity and variety before, including 5-pound, I believe, bags of tobacco. And the things look like bales of weed. And it's just, they're huge. And I can't imagine smoking that much. But that's
over time.
I gotta imagine the tobacco would go stale before you get through all of it. To be honest. But I know that if you've got more than one multi-pack-a-day smoker in the house, that would probably not be a big deal. Now, some other interesting things in there. Homebrew beer kits. Hard cider. And homemade root beer kits. One or more of those is going home with me probably before Christmas. I have not decided which ones I'm going to get yet. The guy behind the counter had actually made up a batch using the home root beer kit. I'm not normally a root beer fan. It's just not something I'm into unless it has to be exceptional. This shit was. It was really excellent. Plus the fact that you are brewing it, and if you let it go longer than they recommend, you will have an alcoholic root beer. I know. I've never partaken of one.
Me either.
Apparently they do sell at the liquor stores, but I have never had root beer, and you would think with the name beer in it, it has, at some point in time, somebody must have root beer, birch beer, it had to have an alcoholic content at some point. But you can brew it, and it will get maybe like a 3% alcohol, like in a standard beer, but in a root beer. And I want to try one of those in a floater.
No doubt.
You'll be floating more ways than
one. The stuff was really good, and like I said, this is if you get the chance, and we're just putting up because I stopped in there, I grabbed a cigar and a couple of smoker candles to help get some of the smoke out of my apartment. I love the smell of a good cigar. Stale cigar smoke reeks.
It does.
Yes. There's not enough Febreze on the planet to get it out of a truck. When I've had when I was doing the whole slip seating thing with a heavy smoker, for somebody who doesn't smoke, you might as well, because by the time you get out of that truck at the end of the week, you will have the equivalent of a contact buzz from 6 or 7 packs of cigarettes. It's just, it's horrible.
Jack wants to know if this place has a website.
All right, let's see what we got here. Okay, it is a chain. RollisTobacco.com, RollisTobacco, tobacco.com. They're changing a few things there. I grabbed the card they had. Okay, on an average, when you roll your own, you save about 59 to 60%
pre-roll. The thing is, there was a place in Erie.
Yeah.
That was a roll your own.
Yeah.
And
I heard about those.
And it eventually shut down because that particular loophole in the tobacco tax law was closed.
Has not been closed yet. However,
that place is done. It's closed for a couple of years now. Because I used to buy cigarettes from there.
Something must have happened because you can still, it's still a hell of a lot cheaper. And the tobacco is not that expensive. I'm not sure what the deal is.
Well, I just remember how pissed off I got because, you know, government cannot allow the people, the sheeple, to save money.
Well, see, this is another thing, and this is what I wanted to talk to. Because on their register, they had a post-it note stating there's a certain Senate bill that is looking to jack the roll-your-own tobacco prices, just like what you're talking about, by 1,400%.
See, I thought this was a done deal. That's why that place in Erie closed.
They still got the sign posted at their register, and it's all news to me. And the tobacco in there is still in the back. That place in the corner there should close up if that was the case.
I would think. I mean, this was big news up in Erie. I mean, they had the guy was on TV and he was in the newspaper and everything, and he was saying if people are going to have to, you know, pay regular price,
right?
They're not going to bother. And
according to
he shut his doors.
No.
Well, once again, government interference, shutting down small business.
Okay, he may have decided to.
He got out of Dodge before.
Get out of Dodge before it happened. That way, he sold off his inventory, got out of Dodge, and was able to keep the profits without having to give that 1,400% increase in taxes to the state or federalities.
That may be possible. Now, take a look at what was in there with tobacco. And for 1 pound bag, the tax was supposedly going to go from $2.60 or something like that on a 1 pound bag of tobacco, close to $50 for a 1 pound bag in tax. That's what the Senate bill was supposed to be all about. Apparently, it hasn't happened. Maybe it's been pushing through all this time,
I was.
But it has not happened.
I was under the impression that it went through, and that was that. And I don't know if that was a federal thing or a state thing.
Well, see, if that was, that's why. And once again tonight, I'm hoping that one or both of the people I talked to today are listening tonight. If you are, and we have not done a PBS yet, so we'll do that here, and as soon as I finish this up, guys. If you're listening to the show tonight, first of all, if this is your first time, once again, we're sorry.
We're sorry.
but I did warn you.
But you chose.
I did warn you.
You chose to be here.
Yeah, I let them know. Sugar up 8-year-olds that are drinking. Understand that, and you'll understand how this show is going to roll out.
After the PBS thing, I want to come back to this with a caveat that I read about today, or not today, yesterday, but could not get the story to print out.
Okay, we'll talk about that here in just a sec. All right, once again, anybody who was I met at Rolly's today, contact us. We'll give you the contact information. We need to find out if this thing is still an ongoing concern, or if it's a done deal, or if it's been killed in committee, or what's going on. But the fact that you still had the post-it up in your shop leads me to believe that you're more on top of it than we are. Maybe that guy up in Erie just got the hell out before he knew
he
was going to bury him. Could very well
be. I remember being pissed off for a really, really long time because I was saving a hell of a lot of money on cigarettes.
Okay, so you know.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And which is, if it was not the case, I can't imagine that the number of people I saw in that little shop today, again, if you didn't know it was there, you'd have a hard time finding it. But there were a lot of people coming in there, buying their tobacco and rolling your own supplies. A lot of people are still doing it. So I gotta believe that that little piece of legislation either didn't go through or it's being held up. And I'd like to get some more information on that. I wish I would have got a copy of it.
I would be gratified to know that it was being ignored.
That's a possibility as well, although ignoring the payment of a tax that has been established kind of has a tendency to draw attention from people.
I wouldn't know anything about that.
We'd probably wind you up in jail depending
you
on
and
you
I. Get it. That's as far as we're going to go with that. Now, all right, let's get into the PBS portion of the program. This is the part of the show we don't like to do, but we're going to do it anyway. Marvin Tabernacle, you're not... Hold on. There's only one thing left to do.
Wash your mouth out with beer, boy.
So you can see what your eyes are trying to say. That make it any clearer?
Pepperoni.
Yeah.
Anyhow. This is where we break out the begging bowl. I'm going to do it in multiple language here eventually. That's going to really piss you right the hell off. The electric bill is always something we need to tackle here. We can always use some financial help with that. We are still fighting with the transmitter. Actually, the transmitter is fine. We have a new
amplifier.
We have a new meter in.
Yeah.
The amplifiers are still giving us the electronic middle finger, not for lack of trying, but we can't seem to find the spare parts we need.
Well,
at least not
like
ones that are functional.
Well, as I said, we have one coming in from a domestic maker, not a foreign maker.
And domestic maker, or is this coming from England?
No, this chip is coming from Californicators.
Might as well be a Soviet block country,
but we'll
discuss that later.
It doesn't have to go through customs, therefore it does not have to be x-rayed or microwaved or any of the waves that it would have to go through, okay? It was supposed to be sent priority mail. We had the holiday in there, so that's probably goofed up the mail. So it'll probably arrive Monday, in which case I'm going to be out hunting deer. I don't care. I'm going to go kill something before I go nuts. Anyway,
we do have to
announce that Monday begins the annual deployment of the Pennsylvania Militia.
Yes. Now, we were going to get into that, but you jumped the gun once again, my young veteran. Some people's kids, just so impatient, these youngsters.
I know.
Younglings, what can you do?
Yeah.
Anyhow.
Kick them in the nuts and send them to bed.
Yeah. I'm not as thick as you young I am.
No, you're much younger.
In my mind, yes.
We weren't going to go there. I am truly an 8-year-old in my head. Anyhow. What do you suggest we do as far as the purchase of a backup amp?
I personally, of course, I'm spending other people's money here, not mine.
I got it. Because I'm a year
behind in taxes, about to become a year and a half behind on taxes. Mm-hmm. Personally, if I had the money, tomorrow I'd be on the computer and I would order another amplifier. I found one, same type we were running for 3 years or 4 years or 5 years or whatever
however
years.
Long, yeah.
However long it was. They're down in price, but something that Terry said that we probably ought to get if we do that, and that's what did I call it?
Attenuator.
Attenuator. Okay.
I'm surprised I got that one out.
Which helps prevent harmonics and feedback in the transmission.
Gotcha.
And
so another $25-$30.
Yeah. That's so he said that's what I would do if you guys are going to do that. So that's my personal suggestion, that we go ahead tomorrow after we get back from the show. I've got the place memorized as my.
We'll go up, we'll get online, we'll just order the damn thing.
Yeah.
All right, not a problem. We've got to get there. We are still dealing with strictly over the web right now and through the archives. And
the reason I'm suggesting that is just in case we do find out that the amplifiers that we have more wrong with it than just the chip. Okay. Which is entirely possible because of the age. Because the chips came in from overseas and sat in customs for about 3 weeks or 4 weeks, we have no idea what kind of raise that thing was subject to before they sent it on.
I'll be honest, I really hadn't given that any thought.
Yeah, that's what Terry came up with. He says they definitely know they would x-rate it, and definitely know they probably hit it with a microwave. But just how many times? Because they knew what the chip was for, and they might have known who it was for, correlating,
it's getting a little
tinfoil hat-ish.
But it is always that possibility because
that would have been a perfect time for you and I to slap them on.
Yeah, it would have.
Before the Christmas show.
Yeah. But that doesn't mean that that's actually what happened. Just that they could have been faulty when they were shipped, and they didn't get no better over on the way over here.
No.
Even though they did come to the land of Obamacare.
I really don't want to include him in this argument right now because I'll end up throwing up all the good stuff I've already put in
my
stomach.
We're getting away from the.
Yeah, we are actually. Squirrel.
Yes.
Anyhow.
Bring us back, boy!
That never happens here.
Oh, it happens in Purgatory. No.
We wouldn't let it.
Let's see. Forget the fact we probably encourage it. Alright. We get back from the gun show tomorrow and we'll run up there and get a new amp put online. Hopefully it doesn't take too long to get in. And if Terry can figure out what the hell is going on his end, then we'll have those available to us. But, we've got to get this done. Right now, the local listeners, God bless their patience. I'm just hoping we don't lose too many more.
Well, I don't think we'll lose many, but they may be a little slow getting back. But I think once we get back and the word spreads, because I'm planning on going down and contacting the radio station downtown because they invited me to come down and talk sometime.
You really need to do that. You really need to do that. All right.
My fellow broadcaster would like to have.
Yeah.
Okay. I've been shoveling the bullshit all the live long day. Wow, that's sounding pretty good.
I know how to modify to match you, fuckers. All right. You know, Andy.
Meanwhile,
we're still waiting for you to show up so we can sing National Anthem, and we'll do it. You gotta be here, sweetheart.
Meanwhile, Grandma's
bring my lads.
Meanwhile, Grandma's
meanwhile.
Got Grandma's back at the ranch beating off the
Indians. Yeah, we ain't talking about Grandma. What Grandma, don't ask, don't tell. What Grandma does behind her own doors is her own damn business.
What happens at Grandma's
now
house?
Now stays at Grandma's house. So now, nice. All right. All right, shit, that's messed up. All right, that's a visual I really didn't need. Oh, teeth in or out? Never mind.
You just had to.
I couldn't leave it alone.
No, could you?
I'm sorry. It was.
You could not leave that alone.
No, I couldn't. Guilty. Guilty?
I just had a flash shot come through, but I'm not going there.
Let's just leave that the hell alone for the time. By God, don't you think about it.
Dude, we did. You're the one that
went. I know it. You drift.
You drifted off the straight and narrow.
No. You opened the door. I just walked through.
Oh, my God.
Give me straight lines, and that's the way it's going to go. Now. What the hell was I? God only knows. And he's probably laughing his ass off, too. All right, let's see. Yes, the next rally. And I do want to promote this heavily. We aren't going to be doing anything ourselves here until April 19th, which, by the grace of God, falls on a Saturday, so we can all be there. You'll have no damned excuse. The True Patriots Day. It will be an open carry rally. All Braveheart radio rallies are, and we are going to burn the Tidy Ball Blue UN rag at the rally. This is an overall show of patriotism and support for the Constitution, and we will assemble once again on the green in the spirit of Captain John Parker and defy the regime to come and get us. Don't screw up. Alright? Make your plans, be there. It should be a good time. That's the next rally for us now. Sounds like we got a whole bunch of people chiming in.
Yeah, we've got some interesting emails too for the.
We'll get into the mailbag here as soon as I finish the PBS. How's that?
Yep.
All right. So let's move on here. If you have information on stories we've done in the past, if you have stories you would like us to try and cover, if you disagree with what we're doing here, we stopped giving a damn about that a long time ago. It no longer matter. If you wish to support the station either in the form of manpower, ideas, or financially, please send all written correspondence to Braveheart Radio, 13211 Laurel Drive, Apartment 1343, Meadville, Pennsylvania.
Occupied zone number 16335.
Once again, that's Braveheart Radio, 13211 Laurel Drive, Apartment 1343. Meadville, Pennsylvania.
Department of Defense missile targeting code. Yeah, that thing. Holy shit, dude. Hold on a second. 6335.
That place. Yeah, hold on. Jeez, that time kick ass. Chewy. Anyway, don't grin at me like that. You know, actually, that paper site's coming up off the ground. I'm running. I was waiting for him to fart. Straining's so damn hard.
Yep. I keep practicing my levitation. The only thing I can get to the rise is my hands.
I got nothing.
There's no point. Let it go. At least you got that far.
Yeah.
Anyhow, shut up.
I'm just
hush.
Waiting. I'm waiting.
Hush.
Not very long, but I'm waiting.
All right, what?
No, I'm him.
Get a hold of it. Okay.
Just him.
All right. If you wish to contact us, by email. Well, you might. You might. Because we've got a couple things we're going to do here. If you want to contact us via email, if you want to get directly through to us for important shit, all right, things that you've seen, MRAPs, drones, that sort of thing. News stories that you know is being covered up that you think the rest of the country needs to know about, send it to John. BraveheartRadio@gmail.com. Once again, BraveheartRadio@gmail.com. That's how you get a hold of John. And it goes directly to his various and sundry electronic type device things over there. If you, for the second hour surprise and some poll questions I've got coming up, plus, and I do want to stress this, we are going to be doing a best of show, the first show of the new year. That is going to be January 4th. And we are looking for our listeners, go back through the archives if you have to, or whatever you can remember, your favorite bits from last year. We've already got a couple of suggestions here. One that seems to be standing out is definitely the phone call to Jan. Jan Napolitano. I gotta admit, I miss Jan.
That
so far has been one of the top ones. Another one is when we basically laid into that young liberal douchebag in the Tribune.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember exactly what we did, but it must have been memorable to somebody. And one that we didn't directly do, but we did play here. The story behind the Star Spangled Banner.
Yes.
That moved quite a few people. And those will definitely, if they're not already firmly involved, they will definitely be in the running. It depends on what else we come up with in the meantime. Again, we're asking our listeners to go through, find out their favorite bits from the past year. Something John, Daryl, or I have said when they've ganged up on me and sprung something on me I wasn't expecting and I kind of lost it on the air, which I guess I kind of do from time to time.
No.
not like he's always so calm, cool, and collected.
Otherwise, you never would have come up with wind him up, watch him go.
That's right.
Douchebag. Anyhow.
We also are going to include a clip from the very first show of the year featuring Doug and Joe Hagman.
Oh, absolutely correct. Absolutely correct.
And I'm going to leave it at that. We have some people listening now faithfully that were not listening at the time.
Indeed.
That are familiar with the Hagmans, although I don't know.
We haven't had them on in so long.
And I know
they've been busier than hell.
Yeah, they have.
And let's face it, when those guys show up, it elevates this show so much. It takes us way out of the gutter.
But the people that listen now faithfully, I don't think we're listening the last time the Hagmans were on.
Right.
So they also listen to the Hagmans.
Sure.
They have a certain expectation.
Oh, well. Understand that Doug and Joe they claim this themselves, that when they come here, it's the Hagmans unplugged.
Yeah. When they're on their own show, promoting their appearance on Braveheart.
Yeah.
On the upcoming Saturday show, they call it Hagman and the Hagman unplugged. And
this is one of the few places they know they can go, and they can say, and whatever comes out of their mouth is absolutely fine. They don't have to be on their best behavior. They don't have to be suit and tie. They don't have to be proper. They're still going to give you great information, but this is the chance for them to take a deep breath, relax,
and laugh.
Pour yourself a cocktail and enjoy life. And that's kind of what we do here. We give that, and if we do nothing else, then give them an opportunity to relax, chill out.
To decompress.
Yeah. And that's
they take full advantage of that in a good way.
Oh, indeed. Indeed.
They absolutely do.
We still are
we got no clue why they come here.
No, and it's
but we're happy to have them.
Indeed. All right. Let's see. Where the hell did I leave off? The poll questions and such, and the fact that we're still looking for ideas for the best of show. So you've got roughly a month. We'd like to have it in the next 3 weeks if you can possibly do it, because it's probably going to take a week to piece everything together. We're still not exactly sure of the format yet. What do you got?
Going back to the smoking thing here real quick. New York is attempting to put a limit on the electronic cigarettes and how many times you can smoke it.
What?
Yes.
What?
I tried to pull the story up, but it would not come.
I did hear something about that.
This is a new one on me.
They're going after the e-cigarettes, even smoking one in public places. Mm-hmm. If you're using an e-cigarette in a public place, they're considering it the same thing as smoking a cigarette. Yeah, I know. I don't know how far that's going to go.
Get the fuck out of my life!
Indeed. New York State. New York State. Nanny State.
Stop telling me what I can't do!
They're becoming homeless. Oh. Californicators.
Now, granted, we're not in New York. We don't have to deal with this, but...
What gets a foothold there will eventually trickle into others unless you're ready to take up arms.
And it still affects fellow Americans.
Yeah. And it's got to be stopped. It's got to be stopped. I don't care what we got to do. I got an idea of what we could do that'll put it right to a screeching halt, but that would probably get me thrown in prison right now. So I'm going to use that information as you will, okay? Once again, for the second hour surprise, if you have any musical suggestions, if you have anything for the poll questions I've got coming up, and it'll probably be another couple weeks before I finagle this right. And for definitely suggestions for... Relax, dude.
I lost my ash.
Kick his ash. All right. He's losing it all over the place. Suggestions for the best of show. Go through the archives if you got time. Find out anything or whatever's been sticking in your mind. Something that you particularly enjoyed. The reason that you come back here. Which we have no freaking...
No, we don't.
No. So the reason you come back. Let us know. We need to know the show, the date of the show... And roughly the timestamp. Follow it along on your player and find out about when it is so we can locate it.
Yeah, if you can't come up with that, give us as much info as you can.
Yeah,
absolutely. And it, that'll give us, because Mike and I are both basically going through each show.
We're trying to.
And picking out.
Things that we like.
Yeah, things that we like.
And folks, and this is a strictly a personal request, please... Please get these requests in, because if we leave it to these two guys, it's going to be 3 hours of fart jokes.
Damn, Darryl, our secret's out.
Well, I was going to throw in Americans with no ability.
No, hold on. But that's absolutely, if we can find that.
That should be around April. It should be around April.
I got to hunt for that, because that's too good not to play. it was from a year previous, but we replayed it during this year, and because it was so good, we need to revisit it. It was a case of where Darryl absolutely caught me flat-footed.
Was I? This will give a little bit of a clue as to when it was played.
Yeah.
The night you guys played that, I don't think I was here.
You were
at home. You couldn't make it down for whatever reason. You were at home.
That's going to help. Because all I got to do is listen to the opening of each show.
And if you don't hear you,
well, if you say that I'm not here, then I know that I got to listen to that show and pick it out.
Gotcha.
If I'm here, I can skip right by.
Right. Okay.
That'll help.
The Americans with No Abilities Act. I'm going to leave it at that because I don't want to throw any spoilers out there. It was just too good.
Holy shit, that was.
It was too good. Once again, that email there is braveheartradio@gmail.
Hotmail.
Excuse me. Gmail is for you. Hotmail. braveheartradio@hotmail.com. God bless America.
Wow, dude.
I got... My mind's going about 100 miles an hour trying to get ahead of things here.
Yeah.
Important stuff. Gmail account. Fun stuff is the Hotmail account. Okay, braveheartradio@ either one. Figure it out there. If they cross over, that's fine. We'll figure something out.
Oh, yeah. If
we're just trying to keep it as cleaned up as we possibly can.
I can certainly forward anything that might be more appropriate for you. Indeed.
Once again, if you're going to send a donation, if you're going to send a check, please leave the payee blank or make it out directly to Darryl Civic. That way it can be taken care of. If you're going to send cash, please wrap it in something. Greeting cards this time of the year would be sweet. Add a little color to this booth. Barring that, aluminum foil. Patch our hats. We can always use that.
And the whole idea is to keep the unscrupulous types from seeing what you're sending through the mail and pocketing for themselves. And of course, as always, gold and silver are greatly appreciated. Constitutional money! Hey, concept! Silver rule! Exactly. Dying seal of approval. The great seal. Oh, never mind. They gotta get you a seal costume or something. Easy, dude. Just smoke and shut up.
He's chomping at the bits.
Don't eat that. Anyway. Constitutional money. We will never see it again. I could do a 2-hour show on just that concept on the Federal Reserve and all that nonsense. We ain't gonna do that right now. All right, that was the PBS. We got about 10 minutes left in this hour, give or take. John, the mailbag. What do we got?
The mailbag!
The person bag. No, bullshit. It's a mailbag. Shut the fuck up.
I just got that. From our our good friend Chris sent this tonight, a humorous sign. Welcome to Highway Sign. Welcome to New York. You are under arrest. Andrew Cuomo, Emperor. Excellent. Good one, Chris. From Mr. T. Braveheart crew, happy Thanksgiving. Hope you guys had a good holiday. I will have to archive tonight's show as I will be having dinner at my in-laws.
I understand that.
That was my edit. I have been doing some research on armored vehicles in PA. I found a couple more counties with one. The PA State Police do have one in Harrisburg. The one in Allegheny County is operated by the Pittsburgh PD. I also found some PR shots of Mercer County's Bearcat and a comment from a PA sheriff as to why they got an armored vehicle. Hope to have that for you before next weekend.
Oh, we could use that, definitely. Yes. Definitely.
Starting Monday, I will be doing the non-PC thing of hunting Bambi's relatives.
And we need to get into that here in just
I do not discriminate between bucks and does. They both taste good.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
Remember,
I'm just fine at that.
Remember, PETA, people eating tasty animals. Yum. Sincerely, Mr. Yum. Leonard.
Still too high.
Oh, let's see. There was one in here. Where'd it go?
There's someplace.
Come on.
It's in your pocket.
Patience, young Jedi.
Oh yeah, we have from Leonard. We have the actual letter that was sent to New York residents.
Oh, good.
Pertaining.
Aha! Aha! Ha! Yes.
Pertaining to we know you've got it. Turn it in or get rid of it. Now, this one that prompted me to write a blog post. Heads up. This is from Leonard.
Okay, copy.
Titled Heads Up. John, the regime seems to be in panic mode when shills and agent provocateurs are activated so sloppily. See article link. There is a special stupid only the MSM buys. Bathhouse Barry needs a distraction. Watch your six. Regards, Leonard. And the title of the article that he sent us.
Okay, I remember now, yes.
Militia leader publicly threatens president. Yes. We now have authority to shoot Obama. He did this publicly on Facebook, of all places.
Yeah, that's almost completely transparent.
Well, now, as I said, I wrote a blog piece about this.
Keystone 3. Check it out. Google it. You'll find it.
Yeah. The title of the article is Stupid Is As Stupid Does. And the way Leonard presented the story is this is a false flag.
Right.
Okay.
That's what I'm thinking.
I'm not so sure. And I wrote this in in my blog. Our friend Leonard alludes to the possibility that this could be a false flag meant to stir up more trouble for militias and the gun culture as a whole. I'm not so sure. This is me speaking. I'm not so sure. My gut tells me this jerk-off is just shooting his mouth off out of frustration. Be that as it may, he has just earned himself elite status in the Idiot of the Month Club, and no small amount of trouble from .gov. Listeners to the show and readers of this blog know I am no stranger to proclaiming the need to take care of business. But I never say it from an offensive standpoint. My perspective on the coming troubles is strictly from the defensive side of the fence. Threatening POTUS like this is not only a one-way ticket to whatever hole they decide to put him in, it is also very counterproductive to the movement in terms of winning hearts and minds. As much as I dislike the president because of his policies, not his skin color. That was all caps.
I got you.
I do not want any physical harm to come to him. In my opinion, that would be the final straw that would ultimately tear this country apart.
Remember what I've said before. And as a quick aside, you don't want this guy dead. That makes him a martyr. And all the unconstitutional crap he's done since he's been here suddenly gains legitimacy as a martyred president.
Yep.
Take a look at Kennedy. Whatever you happen to think of the man personally, Kennedy is now considered a saint by everybody. Unless you actually look back into history and realize he was a flawed human like everybody else. Because he was a martyred president. We do not want that for Barry. And it will happen if anybody takes him out. I don't want to see him killed. I want to see him shamed. I want to see him discredited.
I want to see him rot in prison.
I'll just be happy to get rid of him. Although, yeah. He's already talking about him and his family hanging out in D.C. until 2017. Yeah. Continue.
Never mind the fact that he himself has created the deep divisions that now exist, but I digress. Fact is, the country is so delicate right now because of him that the upset that would come from his assassination will push us over the edge and into the abyss of a racially charged civil war. But then again, maybe that's what the powers that be want in the end.
We've discussed that on a few occasions.
Now, The rant of said idiot. I'm not going to read it, but it is citing everything that Obama's done, both extracurricular. Legally, extra authoritatively, extra constitutionally.
That's a great way to put it.
Okay. Granted, yeah, all of these are true. But the man, if he's going to be charged with crimes against the American people, high crimes and misdemeanors,
indeed,
the man still deserves a fair and impartial trial.
You have to do it.
Otherwise, we become them.
Yeah, you can't make exceptions. It has to be done according to the rule of law, not the rule of men.
Right.
Which is what we've been trying to say for the longest time. But nobody wants to follow that anymore, Barry especially, because he can't seem to understand why we just don't do what he tells us.
So Leonard, with all of the due respect, I disagree with your take, although your take is founded certainly in fact, in historical fact,
indeed,
and precedent. I think this guy. Personally, I think this guy is one of us that just decided to blow his mouth off.
I have not had the chance to actually sit down and listen to the goofball rant, so I really can't give you my take on it. Maybe I'll get around to do that tonight when I go visit the website. All right, guys, we got to take a little bit of a break. Daryl, anything before we take off?
No.
Okay, John, you are pretty much clear there. We got some more stuff afterwards?
Yeah, I got some more mail, some good stuff.
Okay, we're going to take a little bit of a break, and we'll be back with the rest of the mailbag. Got one more cut from Silent Force, the 2007 album, Walk the Earth. You're listening to Pennsylvania American Patriot Radio, Braveheart, 88.7 FM. We'll be right back.
What was the guy's name?
Oh, that I can give you.
See if I recognize him.
This song actually reminds me a lot of Poker Face.
Sounds like it. Christian American Patriots, militia leader Everest Wilhelmson.
Never heard of the guy. I've heard of Christian American Patriots, but
everybody likes to use that title.
Yeah. It throws a little red flag up when they start quoting themselves as
being. As soon as you throw in the word Christian, yeah, okay. Yeah.
To me, that does. You know.
Yeah, I'm sorry. You don't have to mention that. This guy looks like he's about.
I was gonna say, it looks like he's
three bricks shy of a load.
Looks like he's been out on a hiatus of the marijuana plant for the last 6 weeks. You know, he's just his eyes just look like he's drugged. And see, that's the kind of guys give the militia a bad name.
Indeed.
That kind of stupid comment.
Well, like I said,
I don't like presidents. I want him gone, but I want it done in a justified manner under the Constitution.
Yeah.
Under the Constitution. I brought the Medal of Science down. They're all behind me. The one from John is at the very bottom.
Where are they?
They're right there underneath the air conditioner.
Copy that. I ain't gonna do that to him. I ain't gonna give him his stuff for Christmas.
Well,
we probably ought to shut the hell up because nothing's still recording us.
Oh, I forgot about that. Back up.
Mandy must not be listening. She must be off doing other things.
She did do a research.
Did she?
I've been checking when we can't remember what the hell we did where we were all singing together. What the hell was that? Where we were all.
What's that now?
The part where we were all singing together.
I've been shoveling the bullshit.
Oh, yeah. Squirrels in three-part harmony.
Who said that?
I don't know how to read this one. But apparently, over an hour ago, I got a call in to stop sucking my gut in and stop looking at myself because it's okay, I'm fine.
Here was we got. Nine.
Yeah, one dropped off. You scared somebody away.
Yeah.
I reminded John I won't be here next week because of Kathy's Christmas party for where she works.
Okay. Now, are you thinking that you're going to go to Mickey's with us or what?
I don't know.
Next week we're going out.
Okay. Thanks for telling
me.
Give me a week's notice. What do you want?
The party kind of gets dead about...
I have to wash my hair, I can't tell.
The party kind of goes dead about 10, 9:30, 10 o'clock.
Okay.
You stand around and talk to everybody until 1 o'clock if you want. I don't like to do that. I don't know. Most of the people down there where she works don't have enough brain power to fill that wine glass.
Oh boy. That bad, huh?
That bad. Okay.
If
are we back?
You are listening to Crawford County.
Oh, okay.
End of the song.
News and information. Pennsylvania American Patriot Radio.
If I can touch a disc of that Silent Force if you want.
Yeah, I'd like that.
Okay. You seem to like that.
Yeah, it is good stuff.
Like I said, prog metal is most of what I listen to these days. A little bit of everything, obviously, but that's my main stuff. All right. Obamacare coming for the guns, of course. They're asking to tell the doctor to ask you if you have any guns. This one I want to talk about. What the fuck is this? School lesson portrays Obama as Messiah.
Stay in Wonderland.
I want to talk about that. I don't know what the hell that's all about. We're going to find out.
All I'm offering is the truth. Nothing more.
Hip kitty. We're leaning into that one. Let's play it.
Are you sure?
It brought it up. Long, long lead in.
Long lead in, okay.
Let's see what the hell this will be. Huh. Teacher faces discipline for a letter about smelly children?
She sends a letter to the parents of the students in her class because some of them stink.
Yeah.
Need a bath.
Yeah.
Okay. She may have been able to use more tactful, but she's telling the truth, and it's only for the kid's own good to, you know, be clean once in a while. And some of the parents objected to the letter.
Post the link to that rant you guys were discussing before the break around 8.
That?
Somebody wants us to.
Second.
Can you post a link to that rant you guys were discussing before the break around 8? I wonder if he's talking about my blog post.
Yes. Yeah. Well, it was considered a rant because you got a little more vocal.
Generated?
Yeah. And I don't know why you were doing it. But post the link to your,
I'm gonna.
Just say, I hope this is what you're referring to, and then put it in that.
Indeed. Pre-kindergarten. Well, pre-kindergartners do generally smell bad.
They're probably still playing around with their diapers.
Exactly correct. This is somebody who's supposed to be teaching 3 and 4 year old kids. They're poop machines, okay? That's all they really can do at that stage of the game. They do it well, but
mustard makers.
I'm sorry, you're. This woman should not be teaching these kids if she didn't know what she was getting into. You have to have a certain type of person to be able to tolerate that. I couldn't.
Especially, like you said, the age group that she's dealing with.
That's exactly what I meant.
And even still, she could have been a little more tactful about it.
It's a health and safety concern. It also makes it difficult for me to be even close to them or want to touch them. Enough said. Apparently, she has no kids of her own.
Probably not.
I would imagine that would be the case.
I can almost guarantee it.
Probably not. There's always people out there trying to tell you how to raise your kid and never had a kid. And I tell them, until you walk a mile in my shoes, shut the fuck up.
That's like bureaucrats.
We may have to do this song a little more often.
That's like bureaucrats sitting in a cubicle writing regulations for firefighters and EMS personnel that have never done the job.
No doubt. Go through the damn training, then tell me about it.
Go fight a couple of fires, too.
Yeah, pull a couple bodies out of a river.
Or try taking somebody unconscious out of a second story window down a ladder. with an air pack on.
Carry someone's head to the coroner at a car accident. Yeah, fuck you.
You people have no clue. No clue.
No.
I do have a public service announcement if we got some time tonight. I don't know how much we really got to cover here. Earl, you know which
this Earl Pitts here is something that
he definitely wants to get to that. That's good stuff.
The first one, both of them are apropos for what's going on in our country, but this one, the first one, really nails.
Okay, is it funny or is it
satire on seriousness, like we
like us? Do. I'm just trying to figure out where to fit it in. Maybe I'll sit in the PBS until next week, because it was probably going to take about 10 to 15 minutes. Just about.
If we don't make it to some of those other stories, that don't matter.
And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. You're listening to the third hour. Pennsylvania American Patriot Radio. Braveheart. 88.7 FM here in Meadville, Pennsylvania.
That'd be us.
Kind of, sort of.
Not the guy next door, but us.
Just out of curiosity. It's 30 degrees in beautiful Meadville, Pennsylvania. At the top of the hour, a song that I'm beginning to think we don't play nearly often enough. Band is called Hit Kitty, and Will You Save the Hero? And we could probably do an entire hour on the theme behind it, the piss poor treatment of our veterans when they come back. But I really don't want to get that wound up this late in the show, otherwise I'm not going to get any damn sleep tonight. I tend to get a little wound up about certain things, and I know our especially our Twitter followers, I know you guys do too. Find the music, download it, play it wherever you can. There's nothing better than having that jamming in your car as you go by and somebody went, hey, what's that? Tell them. I don't think it's getting a whole lot of airplay because patriotic music does not get airplay unless it's by... Philip, he saw you playing with your thing online here. Did you get a new toy?
Yeah.
Yes, he did.
The new toy is the addition to Fat Bastard.
Folks, you ain't gonna know that's going on unless you're checking out our Ustream feed.
Yeah, it is.
That's something we forgot to mention.
It is. Yeah, it is. You're right.
Throw that out there real quick.
And folks, go to Ustream.tv. We have finally decided to start broadcasting videoly.
Videoly? Is that a word?
It is now! Ustream.tv and do a search for Braveheart Radio.
You'll find us.
Oh boy. Sorry.
Much to your chagrin.
But, anyway, Philip, I am, Fat Bastard has an addition. It is a flashlight, or rail light, flashlight, strobe light, and I need a red dot. So there.
Which kind of disturbs the hell out of me when he's flashing that thing around here. Those, you do not want to see that on you. No,
you don't.
Nine next. Yes.
And for the record, I just pointed my gun at Daryl. It's wide open. There's no magazine in the well. Okay?
And he's still maintaining proper trigger discipline.
I'm keeping my bugger hook off the bang switch.
Thank you for remembering that one. Thank you. Visitors to Keystone 3 will notice that 99 and 44 one-hundredths of the babes that are on there maintain trigger discipline. When I post what I call the daily rape whistle, it's hot chicks with guns. Well, I'm having a hard time finding some new ones. Stop it. Some people's kids.
Sorry.
Some people's kids. Anyway. Warren, buddy,
while the video feed catches up, keep an eye on Mike's face.
No doubt.
I want you to know, John, the last time somebody put a red dot on me, I drew down on it.
Yeah, actually he did.
So
sweet.
Yes, that's the nature of the beast.
You don't. You just don't screw around with me, because you never know what I'm going to do. I can come unglued real quick. I know
he generally doesn't.
But I'm just yeah. letting you know. Yeah, I know right. the gun was in that, and you were trying to demonstrate. But now, I'm just saying.
What the hell was I? Before John
started hip kidding.
Targeting my ass.
Hip kidding.
Shit. I think I was beyond that. I was on to something else, but it doesn't matter. Yeah, once again, folks, check out Hip Kitty online and get their music. They're doing some great stuff out there. All right, let's see. When we last left our heroes, we were discussing the mailbag. And I guess John had a couple more things he wanted to discuss. What do we got?
Yeah, let me bring it back up.
Yeah, bring it up.
Crap. Crap, man! Give me a second here. I was...
One.
Two.
Here, three!
You said a second.
Yeah, I know. He said one second, we gave him two.
See, he's already abused the privilege.
Yes. Hard times from Leonard.
Mm.
You know, the regime is in deep manure when...
Deep kimchi. Yes.
Bowie has to buy Twits to follow him and provide himself with his own hecklers. Good thing he has...
Okay, I know what he's talking about. Yep.
Yesterday's heckler at Obama's pro-amnesty speech in San Francisco.
San Francisco!
Was...
Where God Save the Queen takes on a whole new meaning.
None other than Zhu Hong, an approved guest
he
of
was?
The White House.
Zhu Hong?
Him hung.
That's Japanese for a well-endowed Jewish man.
Approved. All right, that's messed up. All right.
Best I can do off the top of
my head. I get you. Rayvon McDuff.
An approved guest of the White House and an illegal alien from South Korea who recently graduated from UC Berkeley.
Oh. Wow.
Whoa.
Did we hit all the bases there or not? Hold on.
Yeah.
We've got an Asian. We've got an illegal. And he went to school at Berkeley. Holy snapping assholes, Batman. Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
And I wonder who paid that tariff.
People who still say illegal aliens live in the shadows obviously don't know this guy. He's on Twitter and LinkedIn. Was a member of student government. Has lobbied for taxpayer subsidies for illegal alien students.
Fuck you and the horse you rode in on, bitch.
And has been the subject of so much fawning news coverage. He has his own topic page at the Cal Student News Student Paper.
He's an illegal! Will somebody please arrest this douchebag and deport him?
You know, no. Taxpayers don't, you simple socialist cockroach. God.
Where'd it go? San Antonio!
Right there. San Antonio.
San Antonio!
Again from Leonard. Leonard is quite prolific in his email system.
He seems to have been very, very busy.
Yeah. San Antonio PD. An on-duty officer did the unthinkable to a teenage girl after placing her in cuffs and rendering her helpless.
All right.
I know where this is going because I saw the headlines.
Jackie Neal is accused of sexually assaulting a teenager in the back of his squad car while on duty Friday.
Another episode of Popo behaving badly.
Yep. Oh, but that's such a nice lady.
An 11-year veteran of the San Antonio Police Department yeah. is accused of sexually assaulting a teenager after pulling her over for a traffic stop Friday morning. Police say 40-year-old Jackie Neal pulled over the 19-year-old and then groped the woman before placing her in handcuffs and sexually assaulting her in the back of his squad car, according to the San Antonio Express News. San Antonio Police Chief William McManus,
No. Give him his due.
Said the attack was unthinkable. Well, no shit. Really, Dick Tracy? Did you need
don't,
a slide rule to figure that out?
Don't mouth the chief. He's dealing with a rogue cop here. He may be a decent person. We're just painting him with the same brush.
I'm angry. I'm outraged. It's a punch in the eye to the police department, this kind of conduct, McManus said. I can't help it.
You are not going to give that guy even the slightest...
No.
Okay.
No. We won't tolerate it for a second.
Then why is he still on the force?
And I think the swiftness of the investigation and the arrest is indicative of that. Indicative, four syllables. I wonder if he needs a pack of ice to cool his brain off. That's quite a bit. I'm sorry. I can't help myself. According
really
to the arrest
affidavit, dude.
According to the arrest affidavit, Neil informed the woman that she was driving a vehicle that had been reported stolen. She then showed Neil a bill of sale, but he insisted she exit the vehicle and patted her down, ignoring her request for a female officer. She must have been one hot 19-year-old.
At the risk of being labeled as a complete, dirty
sexist
old man, there's quite a few of them out there.
Yeah.
None of which I have even this 1 minute for, because once they start talking, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I don't know what the hell you're talking about, sweetheart.
Neil then handcuffed the woman, moved her to the back of his car, and raped her, instructing the 19-year-old not to tell anyone.
Wait a minute! I'm practically speechless, but only because I can't get my thoughts together here. Did this idiot, and I'm being kind in this one, did he actually think that nothing would happen from this? Did he actually think that she would not tell somebody? That somebody would not find out because I am a law officer?
Yeah, he's probably got the typical syndrome where...
This goes above and beyond, bro! This goes above and beyond. You handcuffed, you pulled over a hot chick, got her out of the vehicle for a pat down. Dude, you shouldn't have gone that far. But even an intelligent pervert would have stopped there. Alright? I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt for being an intelligent pervert. And she said, alright, I've run all your information. After fondling and groping and patting her down and getting as much as he could out of it without it being too obvious, alright, you're free to go. That would have been an intelligent pervert. Now let's drop the IQ level by about 50. Handcuffs her and puts her in the back of the cruiser while continuing to fondle and grope. And then raping the girl and telling her not to say anything? Dude, number one, you got it on your camera that you got the chick. And probably showed you cuffing her and putting her in the back of your vehicle. The most ridiculous rapist on the planet would not have let that girl go. You don't let them go. Not when you're doing it in a public place, in a cruiser where DNA evidence is going to be all over the damn place. I mean, this guy is weapons grade stupid. I am insulted that he is allowed to breathe the same air that I need.
I'm just going to say, with that intelligence level, how in the devil did he ever pass the entrance exam?
That's easy.
No. You have to have at least an IQ of 100 to be a cop. This dude is so far below that level, I'm surprised he got out the front door of his house.
I've seen monkeys with...
Holy snapping assholes, are you kidding me? Do we have a picture of the douchebag?
Yes.
I want to see what this guy looks like. No,
he's
that's
pretty.
Not him.
He's pretty.
Okay, see, that's the picture you showed me of the militia leader.
No, it is not.
Yeah, it's the same picture you showed me.
Yes. Then I did the wrong thing.
Wait a minute. Looking at that guy, okay.
Yeah.
The guy has the forehead of a Neanderthal.
Well, like I said, look like you've been on a week-long binge on drugs. His eyes are all blue. You know?
After the unidentified woman filed a complaint, Neil was arrested. A tracking device in the vehicle confirms his patrol car was stationary during a traffic stop in the area of the alleged assault for 18 minutes Friday. Police reportedly said. The 40-year-old...
Faster than a speeding bullet, huh, brother? Okay.
Minuteman, one-hit wonder.
On and on and on.
Dipstick.
The 40-year-old officer... Long, the coup de grâce. The 40-year-old officer...
Watch Bugs Bunny again.
Is no stranger to accusations of sexual misconduct in the workplace.
Really?
He was once suspended... for dating an 18-year-old member of the department's police explorer program.
Pervert!
Okay, gee.
Man, where do I want to go with this?
Boy, he got off on that one and...
Literally.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean it that way.
Dude,
you knew one of us was going to jump on it.
I'm sorry, as soon as you said it, that's where my mind went.
I know, mine too.
Bad me. Bad me.
What I was meaning was, if holy he got away shit, with the first wrong. One, if he got away with the first one because of some doubt, this should open up a whole new can of worms and reopen the first investigation and get this boy for both of them.
Wow, this is borderline. Wow.
Unless there's a statute.
I'm almost speechless. It's just.
He is out on $20,000 bond.
Why?
He's a cop.
You know that
they are innocent until proven guilty.
The rest of us aren't.
The rest of us aren't.
I know personally.
Fuck Popo.
I know personal experience. I know a guy who was kept for 3 months in jail without bail under the Brady Law, and he's not sitting too far away from the two of you.
It's not like you haven't had any experience with this, right?
Yeah, okay, just gotcha. A little bit.
You know, it's a shame that I've become as jaded as I am, because when I hear stories like this, instead of the, you know, complete blinding outrage that I should feel, I'm dissecting it.
Yeah, but every once in a while, I still get...
Yeah, a little bit. Well, see, you do. Me, I still am speechless only because I'm analyzing it, not because I am overly outraged, which I am, but it's happened so many times since we've been doing this. Point here. During the Clinton administration, when some numbnuts with an SKS opened fire on the White House and was tackled to the ground by a civilian while he was trying to get another magazine out of his trench coat pocket and slap it into the SKS. And instead of wondering the things a normal person were, the first thought in my mind...
He was carrying it wrong.
...was amateur. I thought, you stupid fuck. I need to talk to you because apparently you don't know what you're doing. My first thought was to try and correct his mistakes. First of all, why are you carrying an SKS? They were cheap, mistake plentiful, I get that. Exactly. Number two, even with that, take the fuckers back to back so you can swap them out quickly. Number three, he was spraying and praying with an SKS just over top of the fence, bang, 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 not hitting anything. I'm sorry, if you got that, control 2 to 3 shot groups. There's a window, pow-pow, there's a window, pow-pow, 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 hill, pow-pow, again, pow-pow, again, pow-pow, you know, like that. Controlled shots. But no, he's just up there, bang, 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 bang. You freaking idiot.
Not taking in consideration that those walls are probably made out of 2 foot of marble.
Yeah.
You know?
So he was just opening fire for no damage. Basically, it was a noisemaker and he chipped a few bricks.
Yeah.
And like I said, where I should have been horrified and outraged if somebody opened fire on the people's house.
Yeah, try to visit the people's house.
Yeah, indeed. My first thought was, I need to get your ass down here to teach you how to do this right. And that's where I start to worry about myself.
There were so many...
It's the same thing with this.
There was...
I'm looking at this stuff that this guy did.
From Chef. Have a moment.
Hold on. Oh, well, yes.
Yeah. Due to unseen work circumstances, folks, the remainder of the show has been canceled.
The host is hopelessly distracted.
We got our hey, goddammit. You need to send me the link because I know what I'm going to be doing after the show.
No! Never mind! Never
you
mind!
Weren't there, I didn't. You gotta remember, I've had enough alcohol in my system, I really don't care. There. Besides, if I can get some screen captures from that, I now have some new material for the rape whistle.
Shep, if you wouldn't mind, please, in that video, tag Gabby with that, please.
No doubt. Or I send it to my own email. That's Gabby_Hayes63@yahoo.com. Okay?
And Shep also said, Gabby, I think it is more probable he has gotten away with it several times.
Oh, no.
In other words, his victims probably heeded his advice not to say.
I find that completely unbelievable.
I do too.
But apparently I live in a different world. Because I can't imagine anybody going through that and not telling somebody.
Well, I can understand it based on not dealing with it as such, but
I'm a cop. I did this. You can't say a damn thing about it because I know where you live. Yada yada yada.
A lot of times, the rape victim like that is ashamed, and they don't want anybody to know because they think it's partially their fault, and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, okay,
not knowing that you have the right to be beautiful, and you have the right to be what the dressed the way you want, without having to worry about somebody coming up and trying to stick in the ass. Okay.
Or any place else again.
And in this particular case, we have a pervert who's on the
police department. Using the force of the badge.
Yeah. Trying to intimidate them even that much further.
Do we need to start teaching resistance to authority? Because I know the whole time we're growing up, we like to teach our kids to respect law and order, but the representatives of law and order are not trustworthy any longer.
If you notice the correlation between...
I probably got here too. What do you got?
You didn't get this. This is just to Braveheart from Jack.
Okay.
Amateur. Everybody knows you can load an SKS faster with stripper clips than change a duck drill.
There you go.
Way to go, Jack.
Have you noticed that the increase in the police abuse of power is twofold with the decrease in their intelligence level?
Well, that goes almost goes without saying.
Yeah, and that's what they want.
Or at least it should.
Yeah.
When you drop the IQ level, obviously you're going to have those who have a smaller moral component to their personality.
I am Gorilla. I know how to peel banana. Make me police and give me badge.
Unfortunately, that's the type of goofball that they want. They want the steroid-induced bodybuilder type.
Broadhead.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. All right. We got 30 minutes left. Anything left in the mailbag, John?
No, that's it. That was pretty much...
All right.
That was enough, I think.
Yeah.
No, thank you, everybody that contributed this
indeed,
week.
Indeed.
If we didn't get to it, doesn't mean it wasn't important. We just didn't get to it.
All right. Let's see here. Why don't we finish up with Earl?
That's fine.
Okay. Let's do a couple things here. Mr. Bob Unruh, we've done here many a times, and this is Obamacare coming for your guns. This should come as no surprise, but it bears repeating here. The bogus quote here is, if you like your gun, you can keep it, period. Yeah. Thanks, Barry. Obamacare was such a great goddamned idea, and we've been telling people forever it was a... I've almost given up on everything regarding Obamacare, because we told people when they were first talking about it that this was bullshit, and unfortunately nobody wanted to listen. And this is a case where I don't like being here to say that I told you so, because that means the death of our country.
That's three I told you so and so's in one show.
Easily.
Wow.
Easily.
Yeah.
We could list them constantly if we wanted to. Alright. Once again, from Mr. Bob Unruh, a gentleman that we seem to be pretty much on the same wavelength with. This comes to us from World Net Daily. Obamacare has provided rich fodder for jokes, even if they are a little grim, because of its failed website, cancellation notices, and huge premium spikes. One used car dealer in Denver, Colorado even boasted, at least our website works. So it's no surprise websites such as ObamaGunCare.com would appear with a promise. If you like your gun, you can keep it, period. And if you like your gun, no one's going to ban it, period. Unless, okay. The parody is the brainstorm of the Second Amendment Foundation. I should have known there'd be somebody behind it.
Yeah.
I like those guys. With a track record like Barack Obama has on health care, we don't want the president getting involved in gun care or firearm safety. The SAF's aim is to bring attention to a serious concern within the firearms community. The founder and executive vice president, Alan Gottlieb, has paraphrased the president's own words about his so-called Affordable Health Care Act. What a misnamed piece of shit that is. Almost as bad as the Patriot Act. Okay. Which has proven to be false, to underscore the mistrust firearms owners have towards the administration. Mistrust? Wow. Understate much? Okay. You have nothing to fear from Obama Gun Care. You may register all your guns at ObamaGunCare.com, readers are advised. No one can hack into the site, with the exception of the NSA, FBI, ATF, and of course, Eric Holder. The message may be tongue-in-cheek, but the site offers visitors a chance to sign a petition and support the group, which has more than 20 legal actions in process to protect the Second Amendment rights. Okay, well. Signing petitions.
I have something to say. Big surprise.
Putting your name on a petition. Unfortunately, there's entirely too many people that think that that's all they have to do. And once they've signed a petition, however well worded it might be, well, I did this, now they'll have to listen to us.
Really?
People, if you think that...
74% of the American people opposed Obamacare when it was passed.
Exactly.
They listened real good, didn't they?
No doubt. That's exactly where I'm going with this.
Yeah, but see, that was the wrong figure. It should have been the other way around. 24% should have opposed it, and then it would never have passed.
Well, I don't know where you're going with that one.
Because 76% didn't approve of it, they passed it. So you go the opposite.
They weren't paying any attention to any of it.
That's right. They weren't.
The whole idea behind it was they were going to shove it down our throats whether they wanted to or not. I honestly don't know how it got through. They bought off an awful lot of people, and I believe that they did.
Well,
because all you hear now is not repeal, not rollback. All you hear is, oh, we're going to fix it. I don't want it fixed! I want it destroyed! Let it die on the vine. It's destroying itself as it is. Leave it the fuck alone.
It reminds me of the lemon. You know, buying a car, a lemon car. No matter how much you put into it to try and fix it, it still don't want to
run.
It's
a money pit.
This duck is not going to work.
No, it can't.
No.
And the hell of it is, I firmly believe now that that's by design.
Exactly.
Because if you remember back to the very beginning of the discussion, and I'm not original on this, I've come to this, you know, figuring it out on my own, because let's face it, I got a lot of shit to think about. In the very beginning, it was all about single payer. They wanted one source controlling it all. But there was enough pushback that the current debacle you see was created. Working with the insurance companies, getting them into the exchanges. But it was done so poorly, it was designed from the very get-go to be a Mongolian clusterfuck from all points of the compass. So that people would get so frustrated, all right, we give up, you handle it all.
Exactly.
And they will come in, and every single health insurance company will be put out of business because they will no longer have a legal product to sell. which is what they're talking about right now. Most of the cancellations are because the policies that these people had before, remember, if you like your policy, you can keep it, unless, of course, it doesn't meet the standards of the law, which is much better. No, it's not. I'm sorry, why does an 85-year-old man need coverage for a pap smear? This is the kind of shit that they
have. Why is a 6-year-old kid
need birth control?
Losing his coverage when he's a cancer patient.
Exactly. The hospitals that specialize in handling this stuff are having to refuse patients because they can't afford it anymore. The health care coverage doesn't cover the shit anymore.
And you knew something was wrong when Diane Feinstein, Frankenstein, stated we have to
Pelosi. You keep
yeah, that was this. Pelosi.
You I keep getting combining those stuff. Two. That, well, I understand they're both ugly as sin.
Yeah, they both look alike. We have to pass it to find out what's in it. No, you stupid witch. You don't pass something if you don't know what's in it.
You're supposed to read it 3 times before it. Which is, I don't know if you've ever seen how thick that damn thing is.
It has to be
read in session. It would take them a week to read it all. It has to be done 3 times before you vote on it. Well, they've thrown that out, you know. Anyway, the whole thing was designed to purposely fail so that the American people would finally get fed up and say, all right, we're done, screw it, have it your way, one payer, get rid of all the exchanges, get rid of all the different plans, I want this, I want that, fine, just, you know, out of fatigue. And unfortunately, the American people do not have the stomach for a serious fight. They are not willing to put up with any inconvenience in order to get any of their liberty back. We are talking about the takeover 1/6 of the American economy by the federal government. Mm-hmm. They've already gone after the auto industry, and I don't give a shit if GM says that they're going public again and they paid all of it back. They haven't paid shit back, all right? Let's get that straight right now. They never will either. You'll never see the money they took out of your pockets for that. And do you really, honestly want an agency with the compassion of the IRS and the efficiency of the post office handling your medical care? Really? What have you been smoking, and did you bring enough for everybody? Because if you didn't bring enough for everybody, you shouldn't have brought any at all. My mommy taught me that. Anyhow, back to the whole concept of signing petitions.
I'll sign one with lead.
That's the only petition they'll understand.
I gotta admit, back in the old days, I used to think, you know, I've signed this, and I signed a lot of them.
Oh, me too.
And I actually thought, what do you do when you realize nobody is listening to you anymore?
That's when you have to get a little bit more violent.
Turn up the volume.
That's exactly it. Because the whole idea is to make your representatives hear you, so they listen to their orders, listen to what they're supposed to be doing. What do you do? And I got this back when I used to listen to Marcus quite a bit. I've remembered this statement from when he was here in 95. What do you do when you realize they aren't listening to you anymore? And you have to decide just how much you're willing to tolerate. I've already backed up as far as I intend to go. And it's just going to keep getting worse. It's not going to get any better. And you have to decide, if you've got kids, you've got family, I know you've got to take care of them best you can. You have to understand. Personally, I think you need to get them to a place of relative safety and prepare for combat.
Well, selling your rights away is not protecting your family
no.
or your kids.
You're going to end up in the camps. Do you think you're special? Do you think that because you went along with the regime, you're going to be treated differently? I got news for you. You're going to be the first ones that are funneled into the camps when this house of cards collapses. And it's going to. We can't keep going the way. Eventually, our creditors are going to want paid. How do we do that?
China.
Exactly. There's a couple of ways that this can be done. Some of the Western states are going to get annexed. Russia is going to come after... Russia and China are forming a pact now as we speak. We've talked about it here before. They are dealing with each other. They both want what used to be the United States out of the way.
And
we have to pay off our creditors.
A quick aside, prophecy says the bear and the dragon will...
I'm not even going to go into that. I understand.
I know, understand. But I just wanted
like
to...
Like I said, right now I'm still having a bit of a discussion with God. He and I aren't exactly... we're not exactly compatible right now. I need to get my head straight on that. But eventually our creditors are going to want paid in the... When we've got nothing, we have no money. How do we pay them off? What do we have? Land. Resources.
Real estate, yeah.
Yeah. That never goes out of style. If you think it can't happen, I can't help you. You have to think outside of the box. You have to think worst case scenario. And when this house of cards comes crumbling down, you might see a token resistance if they decide to start coming across the picking of California and the whole West Coast.
They can have it.
No, I know. Besides, Mexico will probably take that one. They've already practically owned it now as it is.
Jack agrees with you.
What's that?
Jack agrees with you.
Yeah.
Mike is right. They passed it to break the middle class and force a single pay system.
Yeah, that's the way it's going.
And
the hell of it is, we've got guys like Rand Paul, Ted Cruz, these guys here, Mike Lee. I keep forgetting to mention him. Sarah has been out there beating the drum forever, but they don't give her any credit.
Nope.
Dismiss her at your peril.
Because she's got the wrong kind of plumbing, and that is at their peril.
No, the problem is she.
I'm having a moment.
Yeah. She may have the wrong type of plumbing in their eyes, but the other thing that she has...
Not in mine, brother, not in mine.
The other thing that she has... Yeah.
I've been rude before and have said that that's a president I could definitely get behind.
No, not... but she's got a mind. She has a mind that she can think.
Oh, see, that's just it. Her naysayers think she's stupid. And
how do you...
She's not.
How do you discredit your competition?
McCain,
Songbird.
McCain losing the election was the best thing that could happen to her. She's more powerful now than she ever would have been.
I still think she makes a better kingmaker than a king.
But getting back to what you were
saying. Go ahead. Yeah. I bet.
If you are not going to do anything other than sign the petitions, if you're not going to get out there and start screaming and hollering.
You need
at the moon, okay? You might as well call your congressman and find out where the nearest goddamn FEMA camp is. Go buy your own ticket and get your ass there now.
You get out of the way.
Get out of the way.
Right now, all you're doing is slowing us down.
And it's just like while we're on this, I'm going to tell the employees that work for the government. If you're a good employee and you don't like what the government's doing, get out.
Yeah.
Because when this comes...
I've said this before. We are looking towards combat. It is coming. I don't care whether you want to believe it or not. That is largely irrelevant. It's coming. It's going to be on your doorstep before you know it. Now, as you can plainly see, I ain't fucking ready. I can guarantee most of you aren't either. Guess what? I'm getting ready.
Me too.
Me three.
I don't know how long it'll last. There are people out there who are training. Find them. Seek them out. Get the training you need. If you don't have the stomach for the fight, get medical training. We're going to need people behind the lines to patch our asses back up. All right? Do what you got to do. But don't wait and don't hope for some miracle. The cavalry ain't coming over the horizon, folks.
We are the cavalry.
You are the cavalry.
That's it. We're it. There's no place left to run.
From my speeches over the summer, be the carrier battle group.
We have to be. We have to be ready. We're not. And again, this goes, and we've done this a few times recently, the parable of the 100. In battle, there, out of every 100 men, there are 10 that should not even be there. 80 are nothing more than targets. I'm one of those right now. I know that. I know that I'm one of those targets. I am not in any way, shape, manner, or form ready for a fight. I will take a couple, but I'm nothing more than a target. I'm going to die quick. I'll do it if I have to. Nine are real fighters, and we're glad to have them because they make the battle. But the one is a warrior, and he will bring the others home. Folks, you need to identify that one warrior and get with him and train. You need to get it down cold. You learn small unit tactics. I hope to God you never need any of it. The political fight will continue. I don't see it doing a damn bit of good, but it will continue. If nothing else, it might slow down the inevitable. We've been doing that since the year 2000 and before. But as I was chastised here earlier, stop looking at myself on the camera because I'm trying to tuck in my gut. I can't help it. Because I can delude myself when I'm looking into a mirror. I can't delude myself when I'm looking at the camera. I know how far out of shape I am.
And we had an opportunity in November.
This ain't helping.
We had an opportunity to replace at the polls a bunch of idiots throughout the government. Maybe not so many senators or representatives, but on the local end or on the state level, yes, we had a chance to clean house and get rid of some of the deadwood that's in there. The commie pinko bastards that are turning this state and this country over. And each and every election we have until the bullets start to fly. We have to do that. Quit sending incumbents back in office.
Incumbents have an 84% re-election rate. And people wonder why nothing changes? We keep sending the same fuckers back. Knock it off!
Insanity. Doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different outcome. In this case,
Mark Levin, he wrote a book. And I just
got Sandra's attention.
Well, no doubt. I know she's a big Levin fan. And I actually got his book on the amendments that he wants to make to the Constitution. One of them is definitely term limits. Couple of ones, there's some of them that I'm thinking, you know, not so much. A lot others that I'm agreeing with wholeheartedly. Not one of them is changing the Senate back to being chosen by the states instead of direct election by the people. There's a check and balance right there. Obamacare never would have seen the light of day if senators appointed by the states would have gone and said, we can't afford this, we can't do this. It would have checked federal power.
And that was the
idea. Which was the whole purpose to begin with.
Bingo. Exactly correct. That's how we're getting all this unconstitutional crap thrown down our throats. Because we don't have that check against
if you didn't vote, if you didn't go down and vote that thing down, you weren't there next week. We had somebody else in your place.
And yeah, you can be replaced like that by the states because you were appointed. All right? That was one of them. The other one was term limits. And this is a key, term limits on Supreme Court justices.
Yes.
Yeah. What a great damned idea. Instead of serving for life, you serve, what is it, 2 6-year terms. I think it was. Once you're done, you're out of there. Brilliant idea. That way you don't have this crap sitting there forever.
In the state judges for the local election, retention. No, we are not retaining you. We're not retaining you.
While we practically worship the Constitution,
we do.
It is a flawed document.
Certainly. It is still probably the greatest system of government ever created by man.
Absolutely.
But there was an amendment process put into place to fix it when things went awry. Mm-hmm. Guess what? Things have gone awry. Mostly because it hasn't been obeyed in my lifetime,
at least.
Going back, it hadn't been obeyed probably since the amendment that took away the rights of the states to appoint the senators back.
A lot of this crap happened.
1913-17.
Thank you. That's where I was going with
time period.
Yeah, 1913 is when a lot of unholy shit happened. Creation of the Federal Reserve, We could really get into some tinfoil hat stuff here, but we only got about 7 or 8 minutes left. There's so much. Folks, don't rely on 3 malcontents here in Northwest Pennsylvania for everything you need to know. You need to seek out other voices. And you know, we do what we can. We try to take a lighthearted look at it, but a lot of this stuff is really starting to get ridiculous. And if you are serious about doing what you can, and I honestly don't believe the Republic can be saved.
Not from what it has become.
No. The Republic cannot be saved. It is going to have to be rebuilt.
Reset, yeah.
And before that happens, you have to know how it's supposed to run in the first place. This is where your education comes into play. If you have not done so, read the founding documents. Go back and start with the Magna Carta. And start working your way up. Through the Federalist and the Anti-Federalist papers.
The Magna Carta spells out the concept of the common law.
Exactly right.
And or the natural law. And that concept, and the Magna Carta was written in 1215?
Somewhere in that time period, yeah.
Okay.
I used to know it by heart, but
From that time, when the Magna Carta was written, and it spelled out the common law. That is what our founding documents and our republic are based on.
In large part, a lot of it was also based on the writings of a lot of the republicans of Rome. Cicero was a great one that the founders based a lot of their stuff on. Our founders were so much better read than we are. And they read the stuff in the original languages, and we are such a stupid people.
Compared to them, yes, we are. But we are still above the current fray.
Well, we as a people are capable of doing so much better.
And by we, I'm talking the three of us in this room, our listeners, the people of the mindset that we have. We are above the fray in that we know the way things, to quote Rush, the way things ought to be. Okay. We've studied the Constitution. We've read the founding documents. We've read the writings of the founding fathers. We know what they had in mind.
Indeed.
And this ain't it.
I can tell you, everybody says,
ain't it.
Nobody knows what they were thinking back in those days. It was a different time.
They wrote everything.
They wrote down everything. And that's something else that that generation did. That we do not. They wrote down everything they thought because they didn't have recording devices like we do now. They wrote constantly, eloquently, copiously.
And that still exists today if you know where to look.
You can find it.
You know what gets me today, and I know we're getting down to the end, have people out there that keep stomping that we are a free country. Our soldiers are overseas.
Bullshit.
Keeping us free. If you think you are free,
you're not.
Sit down and figure out how many damn permits you have to buy.
I forget who it was that said it, that people that think they are free are not.
That comes to this. That was actually a fairly decent segment. We got a last article here. Daryl gets this magazine in every once in a while.
I get it about once a month from REA.
There's a gentleman back in here. Mr. Gary Burbank, but he goes by the handle Earl Pitts. And I used to hear him on the radio every once in a while. And he's got a couple of columns here. We're going to get just one. This guy's your basic gun-toting, ball cap-wearing, you know, orange vest redneck. At least that's his persona. I got a feeling he's quite a bit more intelligent than that. Kind of like Larry the Cable Guy. If you've ever caught Larry when
smart
the cameras
man.
Are off, incredibly intelligent man, and that redneck accent he uses is just that. It's an accent he uses.
It's a gimmick.
Yeah, and it works.
It's a stage thing.
And he's gotten a lot more political over the years, but Earl did it first. So, let's do this, and this is probably going to kill off the show here. I heard about this new poll they got out there the other day. It said, despite our troubles, despite our differences, 86% of Americans today are still proud of their country. But at the same time, about half of us said our founding fathers would be disappointed in our government today. Disappointed? Honestly. Let me tell you something. At this point, George Washington's spinning in his grave so fast, you could put him on a lathe and carve him down to a rocking chair spindle. Fact is, if our founding fathers was alive today, they'd be all on the Maury show telling us that they'd be begging for paternity tests. I mean, how did we get to this? How did we get from honest-to-God giants, visionaries, pillars among men who created a country with their bare hands and the idea of freedom with their bare brains? How did we get from that to back-slapping low-life weasels we got running things today? How is that even possible? That would be like Henry Ford turning over the Ford Motor Company to the Three Stooges. I won't say a damn thing. Earl, we need to talk. That would be like when Steve Jobs was gone and they turned over Apple to Miley Cyrus.
Ooh. Ouch!
Yeah, damn, son. Who in their right mind would let that happen? The problem is, your Republicans and your Democrats today, they hate each other. They refuse to work with each other. They'd rather call each other names than get anything done. And I got news for you. The Founding Fathers hated each other, too. Heck, Aaron Burr was the Vice President of the United States when he shot Alexander Hamilton. Personally, I like him. That would be an indication to me that they didn't like each other. But they still worked together creating America. I mean, up to the point that Burr killed him. Wake up, America! To all you brain-dead idiots in Washington, listen to a regular American. It's time to pull up your big boy pants and start working together. And leave the name-calling to professionals like me. Earl Pitt's American! Well, as far as working together is concerned, you're never going to see it. I honestly don't think it's possible. Considering the supposed ideological differences between them, and I say supposed because I really don't see any stones in the Republicans right now. The things that they say that they're for, they're not. Or haven't been for... since Reagan.
They've become cowardly.
And even in Reagan's time, mainstream Republicans did not like Ronald.
No, they didn't.
Because Ronaldus Magnus, because he was a conservative. And they don't like that. They didn't like that then. They don't like it now. Mm-hmm. And now we've got a different flavor of Republican. We got the libertarian flavored Republican. Your Ron and Rand Pauls. Your more conservative types like your Ted Cruz and your Mike Lee. And I personally consider myself a conservative libertarian. And we don't fit into their paradigm because we believe in minimum government and individual liberty and freedom along with the responsibility that comes with it.
And that is not a new concept.
No, it's not. It seems new and radical and dangerous, not just to the Democrats who are completely against anything even remotely like that with their collective mindset. Everything's got to be about the collective to them. But your big government and establishment Republicans who think, we have to control everything.
Even to neocons.
Yeah.
We are terrorists.
Yeah, we are.
Because you know, we're free thinkers.
To be perfectly honest, I'm kind of comfortable with that.
I am too. I'm okay with that.
I don't care if there's anybody out there that don't like me. I believe in my freedoms and I'm willing to fight for my freedoms. And if that offends you, tough shit.
Pretty much. We don't have the option. I will not bend the knee. And that's what they want. You will either bend the knee or you will die and get out of the way.
There's only one reason why I will bend the knee, and that's to get a better, steadier aim.
Nicely played.
Nicely done.
Well played. I like that one. Well, folks, we've killed off another one.
Bang! Oops.
Any parting thoughts, real quick? John, we got anything on the
future? Thanks to everybody for listening and watching. The camera will stay on.
Indeed.
After the show, so.
For a little bit anyway, until we're done blabbering and bullshitting and what have you.
Yep.
Daryl, anything?
Yeah, the militia will be taking the field Monday morning for 2 weeks of live target practice, live fire and speed targets.
Indeed. 1 million strong in the state of Pennsylvania. You gotta love that. Folks, one last time. Braveheart Radio at hotmail.com. We need your thoughts on the best of show that we're going to be doing the first Saturday of the new year. And so...
Work here is done. I'm needed elsewhere now. I'm needed wherever outlaws rule the West. Wherever innocent women and children are afraid to walk the streets. Wherever a man cannot live in simple dignity. Wherever a people cry out for justice.
So until we see you next time, God bless the Republic.
Death to the New World Order.
We shall prevail, ladies and gentlemen.
We're on the march, they're on the run, and
don't forget to hug your rifle. We'll see you next time.
Nice.
Here's to you, folks. Thank you. You're the greatest.
I had something I was going to say after the show was over, but...
There is something I ran across today that we didn't get to, but I thought it was very interesting, to say the least. This comes from, I found this on Drudge.
Okay.
And this comes from AP News. The headline, In God We Trust, maybe. Putting on each other.
Yeah, there you go.
You can take our word for it. Americans don't trust each other anymore.
I did see that story.
Okay. There was a poll that's done every so often.
Right.
And in 40 years, the level of trust among Americans has dropped by a third.
Yeah. I did see that. It's.
This is what. I mean this thing. I must be learning. Okay. I must be.
Okay.
Because this thing flew out of my phone and hit me like a brick in the face.
All right.
Even the rancor and gridlock in politics might stem from the effects of an increasingly distrustful citizenry. They're blaming us for Washington's problems.
To be honest, it is our fault.
Okay, you're getting a little too technical. More technical than they would be.
Okay, I'd have to read that again because that's not the way I took it.
Even the rancor and gridlock in politics might stem from the effects of an increasingly distrustful citizenry.
I think, okay, he's got that backwards. The rancor and distrust in politics is why we distrust each other.